Happy holidays, everybody. It is Mystery Titans Theater, and it is our annual wrestling movie watch. My name is Travis Walosh, and I'm joined as always by my good buddy, my best buddy, Johnny Hedgepath. Johnny, how are you?
I'm good, man. Happy holidays.
Yeah, great to have you here and with us as well. Well, great to really happy to have him here after things didn't work out for the birthday show a while back, which is all fine because that show got lost into time anyways. James Hamilton, our part of the Frightful Four here.
Hey, James. Everybody.
Good to see you. And I'm so excited to say the champ is here. We have Boom Pro Wrestling Vancouver City champion, Brady Malibu, Brady Roberts. That's what we're calling him because he's my buddy too. Brady, thank you for joining us. How are you?
Thanks for having me, man. Happy holidays.
Yeah. All right. And yes, so we are watching Grunt from, and there's some names we already recognize.
Oh, wow.
Johnny, you've watched it already. When did this come out?
I watched 85? Half of it. I watched, Wally George. See, that's why I was sold on this. Wally George is in
it. I couldn't tell if there was something wrong with the sound there coming up.
I have not seen this film, and I purposely not watched it leading up to this. So,
well, you're not missing anything. Yeah. I watched it for the show. It's bad.
You're not missing anything.
it's awful. You're ready.
I can tell already. I'm going to kill that closed captions. Okay. All right. So who is this?
It's Mad Dog versus I can't remember the guy's name.
Mad Dog Vachon.
No, that's the character's name.
Oh, the character's name.
Dog Johnson.
Hey, get out of here, Grandpa.
Wheel that guy out of there.
Looked like it was Haku wheeling him up. This is crazy.
This is like an exploding ring match. It looks like everything's just blowing up right now. Is Onita in this or what?
All the cameras.
Oh, it's the cameras.
Yeah, this looks like a raging bullshit.
Is the whole thing in black and white?
No,
I don't. I think this is just to get.
This is a flashback.
Hot opening, man. Yeah.
Hot open. Yeah. No, hell of a suplex. Yeah.
They use a lot of the there's like Murdoch and Adrian Street, but some of the Cali mainstays of the day are in this too.
Mm-hmm. Got it. No, Victor, no Roddy Piper though.
No. Victor Rivera and an old John Tolos.
So the bad guy is Skull Crusher.
Skull Crusher, I heard that. Yeah,
Skull Crusher.
The rabbit Skull Crusher?
The wrath.
Much worse.
For a while, I thought the same thing. I was like, is this all in black and white? Because it goes on for a while.
Mm-hmm. Is the guy in the mask is the Skull Crusher?
Yes.
Yes.
It's like a 90s music video.
Yeah,
imagine Soul Asylum playing in the background.
I feel like I might have a seizure watching.
I was going to say.
That episode of Pokemon.
Yeah. Moose is saying, John Tolos, Moose, good to see you, bud. Moose had a good line about Missy Hyatt to open up the things out. He's like, oh, it's called Grunt. I thought we were watching a movie about Missy Hyatt. Very good, Moose. Happy holidays, buddy.
Walnut cracking.
Yeah, the walnut cracking.
Who's doing the commentating?
I don't know. One of the Bowery Wally boys, George. Apparently.
Yeah.
It looks like
Ben Grimm is on commentary.
It's not Magnum TA, is it?
It looks like.
I was gonna say, it looks like Magnum, yeah. Or like a young Jake Roberts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The mask is
when he was
like,
fit.
Right. The mask is kind of like the Misfits logo. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, I was going for the mask.
It's a choice to open with this.
Oh, yeah. This makes the other 80s wrestling movie with the one with Piper, Body Slam, look like high art. Huh.
Isn't there one with like Greg Gagne or something?
There's one with Vern Gagne. We watched
Vern Gagne
last year.
Oh, did you? Okay, that was last year ago. Yeah, which one is that?
The Wrestler from
the Wrestler, right?
From 1974.
Have you done No Holds Barred yet?
No, not yet.
No, all we did was The Wrestler.
The Wrestler.
The
Wrestler answers the question: what if someone did a fanfic about wrestling with the subplot of that Lou Grant actually hooks up with Mary Tyler Moore.
Ed Asner finally gets
because Ed Asner's in it, and his secretary looks exactly like Mary Tyler Moore, and they fall in love.
So Moose with the Soul Asylum, going Broadway, never going back. Hour of my life, I'll never get back.
Wait, though, no, there's a payoff to this. Watch this. Check it out. Oh. A man was decapitated in the middle of the ring.
Ooh. And he was decapitated.
That's why they kept it in black and white. It's way too gruesome.
Oh, yeah.
Is it rolling around?
This is going to happen in Boom. Oh, great. They're going to be, right?
Yep. They're going to be, yep. Oh, boy. No, the Athletics Commission's going to be up my ass. Setting a precedent. You're the champ, Shawn Crusher Johnson's manager. What do you think about the possibility that he may lose his title? Maybe. Al Snow, Moose is saying Al Snow wrote the... Skull
Crusher Johnson. It's like David Berkowitz proclaiming his innocence.
I would be worried about Skull Crusher even prior to...
Is he had a good burger?
I don't know.
I missed how he got decapitated.
I didn't see it.
It was the Cactus Jack Hangman.
Oh, the Hangman. Okay.
Oh, really?
And he hit him with a chair and popped his head off like the top of a dandelion.
I couldn't even tell what was happening. It was like the first Transformers movie.
Yeah.
Speaking of giving you a seizure, I can't even watch those movies.
That was tragic. Oh, no.
My uncle's there?
Horrified. Whether you're... redneck or freak, you love Elvis.
Shocked.
Oh, this is awesome.
The acting is unreal.
It's all fake, you know. That's the last guy says.
This guy's the guy on the Muppet on Sesame Street.
Yeah. Hi ho.
Opponent Skull Crusher Johnson, some 4 months ago in a championship bout.
You think after decapitation? In a bizarre turn of events, after decapitation, they would stop calling him Skull Crusher. They would actually refer to him as his first name.
Yeah.
After being released from jail,
Mad Dog Skull.
How'd they get Orson Welles to narrate them?
So that guy would do anything. But all attempts to draw
him out failed. Does that, speaking of Transformers, Mad the movie? Dog
yeah. Joe was last
Terminal Mercy Hospital.
Yeek.
Where does this take place?
In L.A., I believe.
In L.A., okay. Dejected
and humiliated. Oh, no.
Wild. It's like Mad Dog of Magnolia. It's hilarious.
So Mad Dog killed himself after all that, apparently.
Yes.
We're still black and white, Johnny.
And we're still trying.
Yes.
You lied to us, okay?
This is why I thought this. This is why I thought. I'm like, when does it go to color?
Concerning the championship title, Dick Graham.
And now I'm bringing out Arbrud Dwyer to address the allegations.
Oh no, back to you, Christine. Oh shit.
We are declaring the title vacant.
Man, having a rough day.
It took 9 years for them to declare the title vacant after he was decapitated.
Well, all the
back and forth,
all the back and forth and the trials.
Yeah.
The lawsuits.
He's still sweating. Can we please turn these lights down? I've been asking for 9 years.
Why do we need this light right here?
This one in particular. Yeah. Really unnecessary. Thank you, gentlemen.
Wrestler, folk hero, Mad Dog
Picasso, suicide.
Why is it? Mysterious. Murderer.
Yes. Or was he? All right.
Oh,
there we go. There you go.
No, not the. Hey, I'm a crocodile hunter. I'm a director. My passion played by Flea. Flea is the crocodile. And
walked into my parents' bedroom, and my. It's just like that Teddy Hart documentary where the director makes it all about himself.
You watched all of it, Brady?
I make a cameo in the first episode.
I know, we saw that.
Pretty funny.
I haven't seen it. I don't think I get it. Where, yeah.
I saw all three episodes. Pretty wild.
I just listened to Johnny and Tom's recap.
Yeah, I did a podcast about it, and I had the good taste not to mention you because
thank you.
We were shitting all over it.
I prefer to not be associated with Ted. Good call. I mean, that show only scratches the surface of that guy. Sure. I think you need a 10 season series to get into all this stuff.
So what's going on?
It's like Philip Seymour Hoffman in Boogie Nights.
Yes. Idiot, Scotty! I'm an idiot!
Fucking
idiot!
Fucking idiot! Fucking idiot!
Stupid!
Dude, I don't know. Mad Dog Joe DiCursa. We've mentioned Scotty so many times on the street fights.
Yes, we have.
Who looks like he smells like empty bassinets? This guy.
I believe he returned as the mask.
See, so there's this new sensation. Whoa. There's a new sensation called the mask, and this guy's out to prove that it's actually Mad Dog who faked his own death.
Got it.
The mask is on his way.
Not bad.
Travis's wheels are turning. I can see it in his eyes.
could be a boom storyline.
Exactly. It's not a bad setup.
That's what we're here to find.
Speaking of, I always loved
a young Elvis Costello.
I always loved Mr. America.
I love the
Hulk Hogan storyline. Yeah.
And then his contract just ended, so they had to write it out. Is that what happened?
They had some kind of falling out, and I think he quit. He quit.
Yeah, it's too bad. Just when it was heating up. Yeah.
Yeah. And what's great is they had unaired footage of Hogan lifting the mask up and showing the audience. Yeah. So they aired that and said, "Aha!"
That was the reason we got him, ladies and gentlemen. We got him.
Yeah.
We have compromised. Mr. America to a complete end.
I loved it too. I've loved that angle since I was a kid, and I'd see it with a Jimmy Boogie Woogie Man Valiant. It would be Charlie Brown from Out of Town, Staggerly, the Junkyard Dog, et cetera, et cetera. It's my favorite old school Southern angle.
Is this a secondary opening credits, or is this supposed to be for the fake documentary sort of?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. I don't know, but this.
Like, this is Spinal Tap. Is that Kamala or somebody doing Kamala?
No, that is not Jim Harris. It's Carl Winslow?
Ladies and gentlemen, the fat
the dad
boys.
From...
It's the dad from Urkel?
From Family Matters, yeah. What was his name?
Reginald Van Johnson.
Val Johnson. He's on everybody's favorite. Let's go inside and meet the man
behind the mask. Die Hard.
Really?
No, it's the other guy from Die Hard. It's,
yeah, it is. Yeah, Reginald Val Johnson is.
Yeah, this is his manager.
Who is that Jack dude in the back?
I couldn't see.
And meanwhile, the guy with Tourette's.
Somebody's really got to get to him.
Hello, Mr. Mask.
Mr. Mask.
I'd like to ask you a couple of questions about yourself, Mr. Mask.
Mr. Mask. Something Wild Eyes would say. For sure. Mr. Mask.
Oof.
Wow. Was this song up for an Oscar this year? In 85?
Best song, at least. Best song.
It was up against Time of My Life.
Brady's entrance. To the
I'm coming out to this song on New Year's. We should just play this for like an hour, like when people kind of come into the building.
We don't even have to do another match. We'll just do
it.
So this guy, this sleaziest looking guy in the world here, is the president of the fan club, the Mad Dog fan club.
Right.
Come on, Mass, take the bomb out. Take him out. Being the founder and president
of course in Las Vegas, Nevada. Don't feel why I had to mention that. Who says my goal is to play this song during sex?
Wrestling tonight. Okay, this guy played an FBI agent in Mississippi Burning just like a year or two later.
Anthony Edwards? Goose?
Do you have a mohawk on that mask?
Yeah, it looks like
that's
it.
Cool.
Yeah, the psycho clown stuff.
I was going to say psycho clown. He looks like him, yeah.
I got to see psycho clown this year when I was in Texas.
Dr. Sweet, pretty cool. The mask is Mad Dog Fan Club.
agreed to take off time from his very busy schedule.
The great look at
very busy schedule running the Mad Dog fan club.
Mad Dog Joe is the man. My one stop. It's my house.
I never learned how to stop a car.
Just keep doing reverse and drive. And
maybe you didn't hear me. I said we're.
But what really adds to the experience here is it's a comedy. It's, yeah. That's not funny.
Yeah.
It's a comedy.
Oh, those are the worst. Those kids don't know it's a movie. They don't know it's the
Nobody signed up on a release form. Those are all lawsuits waiting to happen.
Hey, mister.
Many of them are still alive.
Hey, mister, do you have a permit to film here?
No, it's a documentary.
I invited him here.
Whatever,
man. Come on in.
Great hats, too.
I've seen that guy in something.
A young Jerry Seinfeld.
What's the deal? With the decapitated wrestler.
Since they were kids. Oh, they both had the same foster parents. They went to different schools together. Everything.
Like, you can't decide if he's on vacation or if he's in student council.
Why not both?
Talk to him.
Elaine!
I don't know that much, really. So Joe's mother tells this.
God,
do we see that guy again? There he is. Yeah,
there he is. He's back.
He's the real star of this movie.
It's uncool John Waters.
You guys ever notice?
It's just
to the U.S. of A., and that's where Joe's dad made his living fighting cops. Man. Here, I got a photo of him right there.
That guy's been in so many movies.
So the mob.
There's a completely normal thing I keep in my pocket.
I drew that.
Glad you're here.
They ain't never fixed nothing themselves.
So you both think Joe is the mask?
Yeah, you betcha.
Why do they call it Pepsi Free?
Oh, they're smart fans.
It's not free. It doesn't taste like Pepsi.
Those same qualities are.
See, these smart fans, they know what's going on behind the scenes. They know Joe's the mask.
The John Tolis.
Oh, yes. What's the Jerry Seinfeld is the mask.
Somebody stop me.
Mixing some things up. Or Eric Stoltz. All right. Okay. So, all right. You guys, we're going to meet Katie. Katie's knocking on the door behind me.
Oh, no.
For those of you who hadn't heard earlier, Katie is came to my family.
I've heard good things.
He's a new member. We'll let her in. Yeah, come on in, Nara.
There are three or four
basically. Just in time for the child to arrive.
Yeah.
Where we freeze the
No.
That's Katie.
Placement skin grows.
Incredible. Part of the family now.
Oh, cool.
The Variot method.
All right. Okay.
There's a lot of tension.
Katie's assaulting.
There's a lot of tension between
Katie
and Travis. Yeah.
This guy seems like you have a little bit of a beef or something.
Yeah.
Is there scarring?
Katie, anything you'd like to add?
There's always scarring. There's also.
I barely hear the mics over here, Katie. Surgery,
but these are outrageously expensive and painful. Tattoos may be cheap to get, but they're not.
That's what I figured. Yeah, your chance. You had a public forum to air your grievances.
Entire
and you cratered.
It's like Cindy Brady. It's like Cindy Brady.
You resort to violence twice.
Immediately
resorted to violence.
Entire arm is removed.
All right. And a donor arm
is sewn. There's witnesses here.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas, Katie. Katie, why don't you say Merry Christmas?
Nice to meet you, Katie.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
All right, get out of here.
Merry Christmas to you. I don't want to mess with Katie. She throws hands.
Yeah. She comes at you.
You know what I'm talking about?
She has a team.
Look at this.
Anyways, we're still figuring out the three-person show.
Okay, I think one of these ladies was the lady who wrestled as something the Killer Tomato. She had a match against Sherry Martel in the AWA.
Like Tomato in a bombshell way. Oh, okay.
Get out of here.
No, she wore a giant tomato suit.
Well, that could happen.
I had no idea this was a mockumentary, man.
No, me neither.
Neither did I.
Hilarious.
Lola, can I just ask you?
You guys are going to get in trouble.
Scotty.
Is the mask. That's all. We're just making it.
The cars are pretty rad in this. They don't match the era. Yeah.
Damn it, Lola. Leslie.
Every time someone doesn't want to talk to him, he's like, no, I'm not making a movie. I'm just making a documentary. Come on, help me out. Three children were killed on the way to...
Yeah.
Now remember, Leslie.
The Tannenbaums. Is that a beer can?
Yes. Those pylons only had... Those pylons only had 3 days left till retirement.
We shouldn't have gone to her job. Anyway.
Would you do me the honor?
Was yesterday. This is now. I'll be cool. Be in the
moment. No, you won't.
No, you will not.
It's impossible.
Honey, get up here.
Good morning, Lola.
Okay. Welcome. It's like Gilda Radner on tons of amphetamines. Watch this performance. It's insane. With a frying pan.
Look at that.
Wait, are we sure this isn't a documentary and not a mockumentary?
Okay, we're stopped now. Something's bothering you. What's on your mind? What is
it? That lady hit me in the head with a frying pan. That was
she
fucking
called
weird.
The cops or something. That was assault on camera.
EC Dub, says Moose. You
know, EC Dub.
Okay, yeah, well, the fan club president is Bill Alfonso. I can see it.
Coach? Yeah,
he's gonna start blowing a whistle any second now.
What about lunch?
Tell they have the same dentist for sure. So
there's Murdoch. All right. And who's on the
Boom.
Right?
I can't.
Miserable.
Great haircut.
He has to stand next to Dick Murdoch.
I can't think of it. I can't think of who that is.
So we're gonna make him think and understand that the worst thing he ever did was wrestle against the Grunt Brothers. We're gonna
Grunt Brothers.
The Grunt Brothers.
Just making sure he can still hold that mic up, though. Gotta make sure.
Poor guy.
Gotta do my job.
Take notes, Travis.
Yep, yep. Oh, he's a pro. He is a pro.
Don't ever lose the mic.
And then we're gonna get him limb from limb.
It's like, wasn't that guy in Saturday Night Live? Isn't it like John Brewer?
Jim Brewer. Brewer.
He's gonna do his goat boy
right, wing nut job. Yeah.
She brought a skunk, or is it? Wait. Yeah. Oh, it's a dog in a mask. The dog's in a mask.
Take on two potentially homicidal men.
It is Teddy Hart. No, it's a cat.
Isn't it awfully dangerous?
Teddy Hart is the mask, you guys.
Oh boy, just can't avoid him lately.
Yeah.
No,
that poor woman. Get away from him. Run.
Yeah, this woman needs to run. Run fast.
Later, Billy and Chuck were the Grunt Brothers. Very good.
That dog is sick.
Okay, here's what's amazing about this actress's performance.
All tongue.
I figured this was just a bad French accent. No, she's French, and all she does is play French characters in, like, bad movies, and I think she was in a Star Trek or something. Uh-oh.
Wow.
Here you go.
Man. Here they come.
Ooh, on to, I thought it was going to be on to her.
Young Don Morocco.
Ben's town. Moose Trolak.
That is some beefy staff.
Yeah, that's Francis. You get the guy Pee Wee stole his bike from. Right there.
Hey, it's Enrico Palazzo.
That guy.
They're in Hackensack, New Jersey.
Hackensack.
They're in my neck of the woods.
Is that a real place?
Yeah, it's in northern Jersey.
I once wrestled in a town called Ballsack, Alberta.
Yes. It's nice. Ballsack.
B A L. Yeah.
Bad AC. I know it well. Yeah. I played hockey there many times. Yeah. Never find me to go play hockey in Ballsack.
Yeah.
Hey, I did a tour of a kid's show in Ballsack.
Yeah.
Hey, we've all been to Balzac.
Balzac is not that far from Cochrane, Alberta.
No,
that's not even a joke. That's not
also
a joke.
Wrestled there, yeah.
Yeah.
These guys are wrestling underneath the bleachers at a high school football field.
Yeah.
Keep an eye on. Keep an eye on this structure because it's Hackensack right now. It'll be a lot of different places.
Really?
Yeah.
Looks like it's they must have done this at like a fair or something, right?
Well, I was going to say they're screwed if the airplane has to park.
Someone has a sign that just says pain.
Oh, there's that move. I love that. That knee off the top that Dick Murdoch does.
The cattle branding.
No one seems to understand.
like Brady. We
oh, still hey, 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 hey,
hey. Wow, how does that get really on YouTube?
Didn't know this was that kind of
Dick
movie.
Murdoch has gone crazy.
Good thing Katie left.
Dick Murdoch will not let go.
Dick Murdoch sold them tetes and lost his mind.
Oh, no,
that's where they got the idea for it. When did the moment happen with Elizabeth? This is where they got the idea.
Yeah.
They just went with the skirt instead.
No, what we're
mega powers.
What we're missing though, this
hey, there's
is a
ravine.
Hey, this song, the song ravine. That's playing. Hey, guys, the song that's playing is one of Adrian Street's tunes.
Oh yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. He's in this as well, right?
Yeah, he's in this.
Oh.
Uh-oh, he's got a chain.
Yeah. Well, that,
was illegal.
That can't be
or illegal. Or they got some sort of weird rules in the airplane hack and hangers and
hack it's a hack. Well, you wouldn't understand, but I'm from Jersey. A hack and sack death match means chains are legal.
It might as well be like that movie Lionheart.
Wait a second. It? Did you? Oh. This thing you had over his face at the end there. Did you use this as a weapon?
There's a new sensation in wrestling. Who's the guy in the tuxedo in the ring? It looks like the
guy who
what?
He was with him. Yeah, he was holding a dog.
Single-handedly defeated one of the best, roughest, toughest tag teams.
He's the one
in
who he's sending these James identified as Ravine. That is Jim Brewer. Or no, it looks more like Will Arnett. Or no, Will.
A very young Bill Murray.
Who's last man on earth?
May I call you Charles?
Will Forte.
Bill Forte, yes.
I want to ask you a question.
A little bit of everything I just said there.
Yeah, you named them all.
Hey, this guy.
The man
this guy.
They called Ravine.
This looks like the guy who gets killed at Nakatomi Plaza. He's like, Bobby.
He looks like the guy that cheated on the. Is it like King Kong arcade game or whatever?
Billy Mitchell.
He looks like I can't believe they made me change my tie. That's why he's so pissed off.
Vince McMahon totally is Billy in Mitchell. This movie.
Yeah,
holy
wow.
So
the poor kid it does look like him. Got to
celebrate his birthday. It looks like George Costanza's dad.
This is a Pruder film.
That was Joe's only real wrestling coach. Used to be impossible to control.
Not to your sink, Mr. Bob.
Oh, meanie?
Damn it, Janet.
It was just like a wild Mustang or something.
Whoops, how'd that get in there? Thought of his junk. That's why you called us in here. Hey, Sean Emily's in the house. Shrek and DC talk.
I really miss that.
Happy holidays, Sean.
Oh my God.
Well, there's pictures of the mask in
yes.
high school?
Yeah.
Wow.
Joe's
it's Gene
coach.
Simmons.
Prove it.
Joe is that allowed in amateur wrestling?
Depends on the high school. There are special high schools.
It all fits now, don't you see? The mask.
Jean Renault. That's what he looks like now. Leon,
wait, I'm trying to pay attention. I'm trying to.
Excalibur.
I'm lost. I'm lost.
Yeah, it's a young Excalibur.
If I had that mask. I could put Joe's fan club back on
Salt Bay. Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
Every time we see him, he looks like somebody else.
When Joe was going, his fan club was lucrative business for this guy. And he's been on Skid Row. That's what his
right,
that's why
right.
He's doing all this.
That's why the one stop of the fan club was his.
He's got to get on top of the fan club game again.
That's where the money is.
Okay, here we go. This is awesome. Hold on.
Hilarious. Well, they'll let it out the swears, but they can show boobies no problem, I guess.
Yeah.
The 80s.
Well, the boobies weren't there either. They weren't real. So.
You reach into your trunks and take out a little bit of soap from the inside and rub it in the sons of eyes.
A little bit of soap.
Ladies and gentlemen, Captain Kangaroo.
What the hell you doing here, you
Sinatra? What the heck is going on there?
Danny DeVito?
No, I'm like trying to figure out his.
No, that's the guy. Okay, no, that's the guy who played Laverne's father on Laverne and Shirley.
Okay.
He took a fall.
Yeah. Manage Mad Dog Joe DiCurso.
Or
his old manager.
The guy who owned the restaurant.
Man, he's been dead in the corner there for 3 days.
Yeah.
He's the guy who owns the restaurant in Happy Days.
kind, though.
Before Pat Morita.
Said earlier, he was.
Why bleep the swear?
He was a son of a.
This is the no. This was the guy in Chico and the Man. That done. Now I'm dating myself.
For my time, buddy. Yeah.
Nothing.
With Freddie Prinze. I'm old.
Or anything like him since.
You ever listen to Freddie Prinze Jr.'s podcast?
I do.
I've heard a little bit of it.
Yeah, whenever I do, whenever I hear him talk, he seems pretty sharp.
When I met Joe, I've heard him on podcast talking about his how he was raised. He was raised by a family of basically of all the stunt community in Hollywood.
Right.
Raised him, and he's got the most amazing stories.
Who are these guys?
Oh my gosh.
Is this guy covered in shit?
He is the turd.
One half of the turds.
He's got woolly pants on too.
Yeah.
He's got
like a wild. Travis, don't let Max see this movie. He's gonna want to book this guy.
No kidding. Yeah, yeah.
This guy's gonna be the next boom champion, man.
Yeah.
He beat the hell out of that giant
who's he right? Who's, is that Greg Valentine?
No, 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 that would no, that would have gone on for at least another 15 minutes if it was Greg Valentine.
I gotta make up my money some way. Oh, but we had some good times too. Teamed them up with
did you?
They?
Just oh, prior to the decapitation.
I thought this was Hackensack. Cool.
Yeah, now it's Ocean City, Maryland.
Crazy. It must have been standard issue.
Oh my god.
Hilarious. Tonight on a very special AEW Dynamite.
Hey, you know, it's the East Coast. That's up, you know, that's where the money is in the 80s, right? Hackensack in Maryland.
Hey, to be fair, every Legion I've ever wrestled in looks the exact same, also. Yeah. So
oh, look at that.
Every high school gym.
Whoa. I don't know who the big guy is.
Drop kick in his direction. Drop kick.
One more time for good measure. Carnage is through.
A hop it on.
Ah, you think the big guy's all natural or?
Yeah. I would say.
I was gonna say Steve DeSalvo is in this movie, and he wrestled in Stampede. I saw growing up. That's when I learned that they had steroids in Calgary.
Uh oh.
Creepers, creepers.
You know, that's what happens to announcers who get in the way.
Uncle Leo.
Hello. This must have been pre-decapitation. Because decapitation, I would think all the performers would be very careful.
Oh, is he beating up fans?
This is a flashback to an incident with the Mad
Dog. That was really...
Pre-decap.
You see, this is ECW.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
good show last night. Yeah, quite good.
I have no idea what's going on in this story right now.
Me neither. Me neither.
Not a clue.
Oh, I was gone 15 minutes ago.
This is just a collection of scenes.
I immediately called it.
Okay. They're still trying to get proof about Mad Dog, so they're talking to his old manager. And that's it.
This is like Citizen Kane, is it?
Pretty much.
Yeah. Here we go.
Hey, here again.
She only looks directly at us, and frankly, I don't mind it.
No, it's kind of hot.
She's pretty.
She doesn't
crazy,
take a,
crazy pretty though. You know,
she doesn't take a breath. Yeah. She doesn't take a breath for what feels like 5 minutes. This is insane.
What do they call it? Nutty putty.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to see some stuff of it? Gilda Radner is on a lot of
Kramer versus Kramer.
But the actual Kramers, sort of, like Jerry.
All of a sudden, this turns into a divorce story. This feels like. Yeah.
I want to see Kramer versus Kramer, except.
Well, me?
What? Jerry.
Oh. He was very tough on himself.
So, this is Mad Dog's ex girlfriend. She's got all of his old shit, and she wants to get rid of it all.
Mm-hmm. I need your commentary here so I can understand what's
It's totally the
well, I, you know, halfway through is all
his finishers the
got.
Sled.
We're gonna be flying now free about halfway through, Brady.
Yeah.
She's great. I love her.
Mm-hmm. And this is all one long shot.
You can see the cuts, but it's a hell of a performance. It is unhinged.
Oh, take a breath, lady. Take a breath. Oh no, that poor fucking dog. I mean, you think
the dog did not look well.
I mean, he was
that's the one thing that I know is dogs never know they're acting. Never.
Especially dogs they found outside and just put in there for the scene.
Have you seen The Artist, right, James?
Yes.
That dog's incredible in that movie.
Well, he's just doing the thing that people,
I don't know. He made me think that dogs know how to act.
I just watched Annie, and that dog did not.
Sandy, give me a break.
Sandy was terrible.
Sandy's one through eight were all drugs to the gills.
So scared. That dog saved a guy's life.
These fans were beating on this.
That's
guy
another
so
thing we talk about a lot on this show is abused animals.
It's true. Well, it's usually because Matilda's come to the ring or something.
Well, yeah, we talk a lot of mid-80s WWF. You can't help it.
Or the bird. I forget the bird's name.
Frankie.
Frankie. Yeah.
Oh, that poor fucking bird.
Yeah.
What about Jake's snake?
Jake probably has the body count. Jake has the body count of animals. Definitely. Yeah.
It's the way. How about a heart?
Okay, just get out, all right? Oh, no, she gave him so much movie.
Mind if I use the washroom? It's a number two. Like the guy that
won the lottery. I found all this hill footage, and now she's throwing more.
I was just up there. You could have handed these to me nicely. What's the matter with you, lady? Thank you. Oh my gosh. You think she'll call me again? Mike? Should I call her? I'm going to call her.
I'm going to call her. I'll leave a note.
Bob Crane is all over this footage.
Oh dear.
It just smells like feet. Like Lola. Well, that's a lot of movies.
Yeah.
Brett Hart versus Tom McGee? What's that?
I just hope we don't have to watch the equivalent.
This was filmed out of order. That's actually the print of the second half of this movie.
Yeah.
It's going to get real scratchy.
That's what I'm saying.
There it is. Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, look at her. Sweetheart. And welcome to our home. I
am Mad Dog Joe DiCurso's manager. So this is like home footage that they had?
Yeah, this is the footage that they just got from her.
This is his sword. Mad Dog's
trophy. He's carrying this film, man.
Mad Dog. And this is where
we relax. Watch TV. Just pretend I'm not here, baby.
Whatever. How are you now? And this is our clothes
closet. As you can see, is this the early MTV Cribs or what?
Yeah.
I've always had a theory that any closet can be a walk-in closet. You have to be comfortable.
Well, there's Mad Dog. Now someone else is filming it.
It's like that footage in the shack with the kids.
Yeah, yeah, like Dr. D, David Schultz.
Yeah, Dr. D.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it looked like a very happy marriage.
They were fine.
I've seen enough.
I've seen enough what happens when cakes are introduced into wrestling. Someone went full face into that thing.
I've done it.
Oh, no.
It's terrible.
That's all right.
Took me 3 days to get all the cake out of my ears.
Surprise, their bedroom doesn't have the cuckold chairs. I like it. Someone made a joke that every hotel room has that cuck chair where you can
just sit and watch.
He's at the foot of the bed. Really funny.
The cuck chair.
2 or 3 minutes. They were in the enclosed pool areas. Sorry.
Oh no, the documentarian is like, I had no idea it'd be so fucking sad.
Huh.
Oh, now he looks like Max Headroom.
Angel face. Is this a different interviewer? We're not very
popular. I think it's the same guy. The guy who held on to the microphone.
He's just had a few.
Yeah, he's got less charisma.
He's got a five head.
Yeah. Somehow.
That poor dog. That dog. 100%. That dog does not know it's acting. That dog doesn't know where.
Oh no, that dog is. That dog can't breathe. It's unfortunate.
That means nothing to us.
That is a cool mask.
Yeah, I mean, it looks good. Dog luchador masks? That's an untapped market.
No. Hey, yeah. Anytime you can get a mask on a dog, you're already ahead of the game.
Yeah.
Incredibly hungover. He does. I mean, he looks like...
Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, no,
Zorro. He's okay. This guy is. I can't. He's the
matador.
He's the like a matador.
A matador.
And I can't remember what his name is here, but he's the wrestling champion of the state of Georgia.
Wow.
El Toro Rojo.
A hotbed for matadors, Georgia. I don't think you're supposed to put it over your nose like that, dude. It's okay, I cut another hole. And every time you see
red, it's gonna be me, man. Nothing makes me happier than giant nose cutouts and wrestling masks.
It's so good.
Just in that man, in a Zorro mask. Have you ever seen a nose cutout in a Zorro mask?
No.
Oh, get that out.
Look at that hat. Ooh.
Hey, just ain't no.
Hey, that's
they're supposed to be
fan.
In Georgia. They're supposed to be in Georgia. At least
exactly. Yeah. Freebirds in 85.
Okay,
they just called him. Okay, this guy just this guy just introduced him as a true son of the South.
Catch his name. El Toro.
That guy had one scene in the only movie he'll ever be in, and he went for it. I loved it.
Take your chance.
It's like a Winnie the Pooh ears you get in Disneyland.
I love that hat. It's a great hat.
What would you name him? What would you name that wrestler?
Oh, my God.
Whoa, he's just making out with fans?
Yeah. It's the nose
it actually
thing.
Is. It's
mono. The chicks go crazy for the nose
He is mono.
Mono.
Mono. Just that's why if you get kissed from him, it doesn't leave you. I'll stay with you, ladies. I am mono. Where are they now? Well, I mean,
hockey team,
Athens. They're in Athens.
It actually looks
Georgia.
At a different place.
He takes off his.
He took the mask off. Yeah, he's not messing around.
Uh-huh.
Now the mask is back on. Wait a sec.
Hey, what team plays there in that arena?
The mask onto the mask. It's a big esports town.
Okay, you know, he's El Toro. Manager,
or whatever name is. There's the spot. Thank you.
Oh, that's the one. El Toro's dancing.
Oh, the brute has been in. Great announcer.
Okay, who's announcing this? Ellie May Clampett?
I think it's an open mic night. Just anybody can walk up to the microphone.
Dolly Parton decided to come see some wrestling.
They're bringing it back. Wrestling Tonight reprise.
Have you done that yet, Travis?
On the soundtrack. Grunt the soundtrack. Wrestling Tonight in parentheses reprise.
Oh, we're back.
Holy.
What do you call that move, Brady? The little nose twist. Does it have a name?
Which one was it?
You step on someone's face and then just kind of twist your.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I don't know what it's called. I don't know if it's got a name. Yeah.
Skin the cat.
Here we go. Big dive. Oh my gosh.
El Toro follows him down and is now doing the Toreador in the aisles.
One name gang in the audience.
He's stunned. Now, he doesn't know.
George Goober Lindsay is the other commentator, apparently.
Looks like Al McGrill. Or Al Madrill. Names of the
Toreador. What was it that Kelly called Al Madrill?
Mr. Two and a Half Stars.
Mr. Two and a Half Stars.
Or is it two stars? I can't remember.
Something like that. Here comes about
280 pounds.
Yeah, you see? It sticks in your head.
Yeah.
Oh, the flying bull.
The mask is looking tired.
Someone just oozes charisma. No part of this fight. He runs for cover. You know when he's beaten, El Toro makes sure the whole world knows it. The ref is counting out the mask. One, two. But El Toro isn't finished. The mask sure isn't what he's cracked. Yes,
she's got a opinion.
Why are you really... They're really trying to build up some sort of tension. That's
here we go. Hey, you know who El Toro is? El Toro is Armando Guerrero.
Guerrero, yeah, there we go.
Oh, that makes sense.
baptism of El Toro. The man just took off and sailed over my head and plowed like a comet from the skies right into what's left of the mask.
See, in the middle of this steam pile of shit, we get a Guerrero. So, I mean, come on.
Now I feel bad about making fun of his hat.
I declare. Yeah. I liked his hat.
That's fair.
It's a hell of a hat. He took the mask off once he got in there also.
Yeah.
With the nose cut out.
Yes.
Well, it's, you know, it's just for sure. It's part of the Matador culture. You know that you don't actually wear it when you're fighting the bull, I would imagine.
But the weird thing is you do wear it when you're driving, which is strange. Yes.
That's the law.
Yeah.
But it wasn't to hide his identity, is what you're saying.
No.
Sean says he was his
Beagle Boys cosplay.
Right? Sean is saying people give wrestlers shit nowadays for waiting for dives. He could have watched Lawrence of Arabia during that time.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Nice.
I get it now. I hope this guy beats the mask.
And we do that
once and for all.
That's the move.
Yeah. The nose twist. Wow, there you go. There's our answer, guys. The nose twist.
Makes sense.
Guerrero nose twist.
What I keep trying to figure out is, okay, so Mad Dog apparently had a thriving fan club that kept this other guy in suits and money and everything. Was a heel, and because the mask's a heel too.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, right. Yeah.
Where's the fan club, Philadelphia? Because I mean, maybe.
it's a chicken coop. No.
Oh. Those look sketchy.
Yeah. They do not look iron. They do not look steel.
Hey, these stairs don't meet my.
They have not been sanded down. That's a Splinter Central.
Oh,
that thing has corners.
Is what I'm saying.
Not Ouch. Good, says Rip Torn in the front row. Just here.
Oh,
she's having it. This has been a journey for her. That woman. We've seen her 3 or 4 times now.
I believe that's his daughter.
Oh, that's the first time we've seen.
I'm tripping balls.
Malice behind that mask. I like that.
You just took a mental note of that. He's hurt. Get some medical attention. It's a DQ. Armando Guerrero says, I'm not going to do a job in your
weird
movie.
Had we seen her face up until that point or just heard her voice?
We just did.
I think they should have at least given us identification at the beginning.
Somebody should tell that actor. I think she has a thyroid condition or something. Her eyes are like.
Come on. She's beautiful. She's stunning.
She's fantastic.
I think she's really good. She is. I agree. Oh, like, as I'm saying, like.
Oh, don't let a disease hold you back. No, she's doing great.
I mean, the movie itself, the plot is kind of all over the place. But at the same point, we are still trying to figure out who this guy is.
Yeah, true. Like, have they dropped any hints to this being anyone other than
Mad
Dog, or is it just that's
good
it?
Point. Yeah. Dude,
first thing, has anybody checked if
Wally George? This is Wally George. I don't know how where y'all ever up there of Wally George, but Wally George was a DJ and TV host out in California. He was the original Morton Downey Jr.
Oh, I've seen him.
And he inspired him and through him Limbaugh and all that shit. And his daughter is Rebecca De Mornay, and she has nothing to do with him or had nothing to do with him.
I was secretly hoping it was going to be Wallace George.
Yeah, if they actually filmed this in Hackensack, they would have gotten Morton Downey Jr.
So this is him essentially playing
doing
himself.
His fucking show. Doing the Wally George show. Even when they try, it already sucks compared to the Morton Downey
Russian guy.
Yeah. The Morton Downey wrestling show in the 80s. in piece of business.
Wow, is that real footage?
I think that was legitimate. No, and then people just throw things at him.
Man was murdered tonight in Hackensack.
That was uncalled for.
Those stupid Russians don't know how to do anything right. And
like,
they don't know how to do anything right.
Trying to describe.
Well, can't even George, decapitate someone correctly.
He's got the script in front of him. We can see the script, Wally. Ago,
and I'll tell you, this film was.
Oh, I would thought it was Wallace Shawn.
From the Soviet Union by
it's absolutely inconceivable.
In the CIA. Next up on the hot seat, he calls himself a disc jockey.
Oh my
I
gosh.
Call him a disc jerk.
Oh God. Michael Cera?
maybe young Judge Reinhold.
Lousy role model for the kids
Judge.
You are promoting satanic worship, drugs, and violence.
Come on, man.
Right?
Wow.
I was in the best scene of Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
The best. The best.
All right. Listen, you
prancing little pervert.
Wait a minute.
Oh, you're gonna make a mental note of that one too.
Can I finish?
By the way, why did you put your pants on before you came down here?
Oh, man, he's not just
can I finish? Dude, he's ragging on your shorts.
The name of the song, the Crosshair Band. There's a hidden message in this.
Speaking of distorted,
it's like the guy who runs Barstool. What's his name?
Be quiet now. I'm gonna turn it up so you can hear this loud and clear. Okay.
What the hell kind of show is this?
It's like the framed Richard Nixon.
Yeah.
The framed Nixon in the back.
It's like a coat of arms with Nixon in the middle.
He doesn't know how a record player works. Oh, he's back. Back. Yeah,
can you hear that?
You are nuts. What do you think?
So, okay. To be fair, Wally George is telling him the idea of backtracking satanic messages is ridiculous. So, I don't know.
Arrested? What the hell happened?
Arrested.
What?
I have no time for you. You know how many? You know how many record needles I ruined? Get the fuck out of here! Take him away.
And bring somebody up for some questions and maybe a few comments.
Here we go.
Not this Yahoo.
What kind of a doctor are you, pal?
Sociology.
Also a virgin. I don't know why I had to mention that.
I keep saying it. It's like a tick.
I would like to, on behalf of the Mad Dog Joe is Mask fan club,
we have
the fan club.
Yeah. Every year we give this away. I've won it for the last 10 years, but this year we thought,
dude, the Labor Day telethon just isn't what it used to be.
Doctor of Style. I studied under Professor
Slicks. On you, this one thing, sir, and this is with all due respect. Because I appreciate you, and I appreciate the men you have.
Is that
a
John
role,
Wayne on the other one there?
I appreciate the country.
The other picture, probably. That makes sense, because he's a real man.
Joe
this guy.
Is the man.
Hot seats.
You are an idiot.
I have been interviewed.
Whoa, easy there. Is he kind of?
Come on, now.
He's got opinions about satanic messages and guys hiding under masks who are supposed to be dead.
Yeah. And apparently a large supply of police officers.
Yeah. He was, he was very popular.
Just loaded up on bailiffs, court bailiffs.
Masquerading as Mad Dog Joe DiCurso. And he's bringing along with him his ding-dong manager. Let's bring them out right now. Here they are.
Oh,
poor dog.
The dog is back.
How long did Hot Seat run?
Oh, I don't remember.
Was that what his show really was? I thought they made up a version of it.
Dude, I was aware of Wally George, but I know a lot about him because of the podcast you recommended, the Behind the Bastards. There's a whole episode on Wally George.
Oh wow.
A lot of jealous people.
Purple pants with blue and yellow or blue and silver. Why?
I don't know. I kind of like I think it looks good.
All right. Well, that I can't argue with. Good night, everyone.
You win.
I resign from the hot seat. I am Greg Norman.
And why don't you say something?
Senior PGA, great.
I was going to say, we don't know if the mask is Mad Dog. Has anybody checked for a month?
Are you Joe DiCurso?
Oh, he's asking right now. Are you Joe DiCurso?
Kiss.
Does he have a mustache? Kiss him.
Wally George was surprisingly, ahead of his time. Put his hands on Wally George. Hey, you don't put your hands on Wally George.
He's gonna decapitate another man.
Oh my god.
Oh no.
This is totally Springer.
Springer. I was just thinking Springer.
That's what his show was. It's what Morton Downey was. The Morton Downey Wrestling. Oh, now they're in Fresno.
How do they have access to all these great cars? That's the weirdest part of it. Yeah.
We do exactly as we want when it comes to the media. The mask is ready to show the world. But he's not flash in the past.
Have I mentioned I am French?
He will be arrested.
He's got the mustache.
He does have the mustache. Well, I have a pretty good idea who that guy is.
It's like the first time you saw Doom when you're a kid and you're like, you know, when they're in the masks, I was like, yeah, I know who these guys are.
Who told you to ask me that question?
Nobody. I make up my own questions.
Don't never ask me that question again. Never.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's like a gunshot.
Oh,
like
no.
What a shot.
Like Matt's brains are all over the... It's like the Zapruder film suddenly.
Back into the left.
That was insane. That was so funny. How did you manage to spell mask wrong?
They're popular in that part of town.
That guy just got stossled.
Totally.
Steve Allen?
Meets John Larroquette. Anime Undertaker.
Yeah.
Ah, it's a trick.
Well done.
One ticket
for Grunt, please.
They heard about the boobies.
It's a bunch of little guys. Okay, here we go.
Okay, that's pretty good, actually. That we should do it, Boom.
Four in a coat. That's fantastic.
I do love that.
I'm sure they'll handle this with sophistication and maturity.
I love how they turn their voices into.
Dude, they already gave them Munchkin voices, so you know how they're going to.
Also, they didn't give them any, costumes. They're all just in their underpants.
You gotta say though, shorts. That one guy is really small.
This is the first time I've ever been offended by mini wrestling because of the voices. No, that was terrible. Vince saw this and was just like, "Shit, even I wouldn't go that far." Some of these guys are not wrestlers,
apparently. I don't think Kelly found anything. Was able to track down any of these guys. That guy looks like a little person version of Rick Martel. You see him there?
Yeah,
dude. I've had acid nightmares like this.
It's like a commercial. It looks like a commercial for, I don't know, skin cream or something.
Yeah.
Oh, this crowd is
like, look at this.
Oh, here we go. Okay, the one on his knees is clearly not a wrestler.
Yeah. What the hell was that? I did not sign up for that. That was fucking insane.
This crowd is fickle. You beat up a couple little fellers and they start throwing stuff at you.
Three more children dead on the way up.
Why'd he turn on his manager here?
I don't know.
He threw his jacket.
I think because they signed the match.
They've got dolls. Okay, what dolls? What dolls did they repurpose? What dolls
looks
did
like
they
the
repurpose?
Andre. The Andre. Yeah, the Andre. Sure. And then to the right, looks like could
the Andre
be,
is blonde.
A Hercules, maybe? The Georgia title manager, the mask. Yeah, I think they made the Andre blonde. I'll be right back. Face.
From that frying pan, Angel Face really put the mask into the fire. The mask got burnt. Angel Face felt...
Angel so her face name is Angel Face.
Yeah, her name's Angel Face.
Now the mask has a new manager. Golden Greek John Tolis and remains to be seen...
John Tolis is coming up. Yeah, the goal. Yeah.
Can't bend the suspense, can you? Frankly, I only pay attention to professional wrestling because I can't afford cable television. If I could afford cable money...
Wait, this guy's just spitting truth all of a sudden?
Now stay tuned for the exotic... What? Oh, he hates all sports. He's the sports announcer. Hates all sports. Oh, here we go. Travis leaves.
Awesome. Okay. Now I'm back in time.
Back just in time.
Yeah. Look at this.
The rat. What was with the rat?
Please, somebody save that dog.
If this was a children's show called Adrian Street,
and it was actually a street, and it was like Sesame Street, except.
Yeah.
Oh, that was awesome.
This is a look.
to exotic alien streets, and tonight my guests
he is
did exotic. Did you see WWE did a documentary on him a while back, Brady? I don't know if you saw it.
Didn't see it. No, I haven't seen it. Was it good?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Is it on the network?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's the whole point being Vince would have made him a star if he had been tall. Because he was super.
The new Ric Flair documentary came out today.
Yeah, I was gonna watch it later.
I haven't seen it.
John Tolos,
Burt Reynolds in Deliverance.
In Deliverance, yeah.
John Tolos is a Columbo villain.
Stepping in the middle of an earthquake. Stepping in the middle of a tornado.
That's the coach.
Pretty awesome looking microphone.
Anyone in his way, he flattens. No one.
You're on Adrian Street.
No one.
What about the human pyramid?
The human pyramid?
You're talking about those guys again?
that's what they're called. The little guys are called the human pyramid.
Oh, that's terrible.
What?
And boom, and all so Miss Linda's going full magenta from Rocky Horror here.
Nothing. So they deported her back to France.
Where'd that guy come from?
Ah.
Do you understand a man talking?
Of course
this
I.
Is what he
Yes, but not you.
Nobody understands.
So in the middle of the movie, they go, "Hey, John Tolos is available." All right, they fired the actress. But John Tolos and. I'd love if they actually had an exotic Adrian Street never had a talk show segment on any place he ever appeared because they didn't do them in the South. But this could have been great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is that the French lady? Is the French lady the?
No. That's lovely Miss Linda. Oh.
I think that's Miss Linda. Yeah, that's Miss Linda. They're still married.
So what does Doc Man have to say about things?
Don't lose your head over it, Street. Don't lose your
even the microphone. Look, the microphone looks is all Adrian'd out. Looks fantastic.
Give it a little
okay. give it a little lick.
Captain Carnage.
Captain Carnage. Okay. He's called Captain Carnage.
I appreciate you not wearing any pants.
I'm sure it is. Let me ask you one question. This is the question that all the viewers want to know. Is this man Mad Dog Jody?
Doc Man, does it belong in the upper portion of Raimi's oeuvre?
Let me tell you something, brother. This is Elvis under the mask.
No, I thought it was it's Liam Neeson. Doc Man.
Uh-oh.
Wow.
Now.
Oh, and Adrian Street falls in a garbage can?
What kind of street is this? Yeah, because he's the grouch. I'm the grouch of Adrian.
Adrian Street.
You've made me a grouch.
Okay, Children's Television Network filed a complaint against
So was show. There never...
He's got a real scum of the earth vibe going.
Okay, she's got a Adrian lot of... There was Street. A lot of cocaine in the 80s vibe going on.
Oh, no.
There.
And it looks like she walked into, like, you know, my our college dorm. What came first? Everybody had movie posters up.
Think about it.
Did so? Adrian Street did not have a guy. Wrestling today. Oh, yeah. The mask.
There you go.
There was no that. The idea of Adrian Street or whatever. He never had a thing like that, Johnny.
No, never.
That would have been great.
Yeah.
I like it a lot. Yeah.
Now they're in a so
young so, Steve Austin.
Young Steve Austin and Dutch Mantel arrived at the show.
He looks like double Dutch Mantel. That guy's giant.
Very good. Double
the assistant to the assistant to the mayor himself.
They get
Johnny Cochran.
Jackie Childs.
Personal and intimate regards. I had wanted to present your name on names here with the key to the city.
We must know some of these people.
Yeah, there's a lot of these are wrestlers. I can't.
Snowflake paperweights.
Snowflake. Tell me his name isn't Snowflake.
I hope so.
Hoobly.
Yeah, but it's just because of the cocaine.
Yeah.
Okay.
That is that Steve Austin? No, looks like a,
no, it's because of his LA liberal.
Is that Steve Austin?
No, that's
no.
It says Eagle, so it's got to be. Was it? Is that Dan Spivey? He was American Starship Eagle.
Oh, hey, that maybe was just, yeah.
But I don't know if he's in the credits.
That's the security guy.
Right.
Okay. Dan Spivey. Yeah, that was Dan Spivey.
We're out of the lab. A young Spielberg.
Similar styles, but until we see it without the mask.
Sean's wondering what Italian guy they have in the headdress.
Okay, sounds like Vince Russo, that guy.
Yeah.
He looks like Munch from Law and Order.
Yeah.
So, Dr. Tweed, you must be
Fred
very
Mertz?
Excited about this evening. Well, I'm flying high.
You know, you hit it really hard, Fred.
I do some standalone magic to entertain the people.
Thought we'd try it out. The show. You know, all right, for starters, what's your favorite color?
Decapitation? No.
Can you say white?
You know, history could repeat itself.
I got a dumb.
Okay, as far as wrestling names that I recognize that are in this, I think Steve Pardee, there's Steve DeSalvo, a guy called Black Hawk, Jack Wildman Armstrong, Woody Farmer, Rip Merrill.
Disc and even a broken neck.
Young Dave Bautista.
It's not a pretty sight.
Salvador Lothario.
Oh, man. Let me put my lipstick on before we interview me.
What do you like best about it? I like the pain. Violence. Violence. The blood. The hidden.
It's like we're at the 1991 Grammys.
Yeah. Margaret Cho.
Smashing together. They're flexing and their muscles just bulging with their veins sticking out.
Oh, my God.
See?
Yeah, see,
that's what we all love.
Brady's nodding.
She really captures. She really captures
my favorite part.
She's got the.
Thank God she mentioned the veins.
She knows what she's talking about. Yeah.
Mark, they call it.
Anna Ross concert on Central Park. We broke up a lot of crowd control things. We were.
Oh no, they
still nursing a head injury.
Let me tell you, don't ever count him out. You ever count him out, you're finished. I'll come after you myself.
Wow. Like, who? Oh,
may I call you Charles?
It's Dick Cavett. May I call you Dick Cavett?
So then there's this time Groucho and I were on an elevator, and he looked to me and said,
irrelevant. You'll be having dinner with Groucho tonight if you don't shut up.
You understand that?
Yeah.
Of course you don't. What is this you're making?
Oh, I
this
said I
educational
did.
Educational video. You get a grant
what
is
that
for this.
Name of that guy from Much Music.
Terry David.
Terry David Mulligan.
Yeah.
Parade. Museum. And documentary.
Documentary.
And there's only one thing I hate more than a parade. That's you.
Is that documentary?
It does look like the PNE Coliseum in Vancouver.
I'm going to the press box.
Where they hold super.
And then he just falls down the stairs.
Hey, those are some fine-looking communist tights.
Now there's going to be a lot of big fat men hitting the ground.
I'm wearing the same underpants right
not
now.
Not for you, and this is for the mask or anybody else. Tries
gotta
to
say, I'm a big fan. I'm not super familiar with Adrian Street.
Adrian Street,
basically
yeah, no, he's
the
awesome.
Show.
Like, yeah,
just
no, we've
show.
Seen.
Hey, Travis,
we watched Lords of the Ring, right?
Yeah. Travis, I told you before. Danzo and I, when we were 16, bought the Nikita Koloff shirts at the Great American Bash and just proudly wore them around in Philadelphia. And they fully had this the hammer and sickle and were red.
Wow, awesome. This is who Sean thinks is about to do the Super Bowl shuffle. I know they tell me I shouldn't wear my safety glasses everywhere, but better safe than sorry.
You know?
Why is this scene still going?
I don't know. There's
it's the GWA.
They gotta hit that 85-minute mark.
Yeah.
Wrestling to that. We're
Queen Kong. Queen Kong versus Charlie. This is another Adrian Street tune. I didn't know Adrian Street had a Herman's Hermits phase.
Yeah.
Wrestling tonight. Wrestling tonight.
Big girl for oh my god. Hey, so I wrote you a song.
I am prolific.
I wrote a song for you. I think you'll like it. A mighty big girl for her age. What do you think? It's about you.
You want to be in the movies?
Well, you gotta listen to this song I wrote about you first.
And then you'll see, you'll like be on screen just flopping around in your whatever bathing.
Oh, you have to do, love. You just got to flop, love.
You just got to put on your swimming costume, love.
Get you like swimming.
And flop around. Well, I play this very derogatory song about you.
You should probably listen to the song first.
You know what? You know what? We'll do it. We'll shoot. Let's go. Are we rolling?
We can play the song at the same time. Fine.
Jeez. What a mess.
And that was key to the plot.
It was like all back.
Every 80s card I ever went to back in the day at the Meadowlands had a little guy's match and a ladies match, so they're just they're sticking with the formula.
Right, right. It's a card. Yeah, I get it. Call that a cooler.
She's a mighty big girl for her age.
See, there that's stuck. It's going to be stuck in your head for a while.
I want to mash that up with it's wrestling or whatever.
Wrestling tonight.
Okay. Wrestling tonight, yeah.
Okay, who's the frog-voiced guy?
Like Freddie Blassie.
It sounded like Blassie, but there's no way. None of this time.
John is saying he really wants to hear Adrian Street's version of Something Tells Me I'm Into Something Good. That'd be pretty good.
That's ought to be interesting.
I think it is Spivey.
I told you it was Spivey. Yeah. I looked it up. Doubt me, Travis.
American Eagle?
Yeah. He was... Dan Spivey, you know, Dan Spivey and Scott Hall were a tag team in Crockett called the American Starship. And Spivey was just called American Starship Eagle, and Hall was American Starship Coyote.
Yeah, it didn't take off.
It didn't take off.
Didn't catch, eh? Oh, that's bad.
It didn't take off.
Yeah, I thought that looked like a not well Orson Welles as well, so. Orson not so Wells.
From crisp coating, that's difficult to say.
Ooh, man. Everybody's got a cape.
Yeah, it's a ton of it's a cape off, love. It's a cape off.
This guy, hey, no one told me. Off. Hey, did someone forgot to tell me this was a cape off?
Orson poisoned
Wells. I accidentally peed on my cape, so I didn't bring it out. I slipped in front of me at the urinal. I didn't.
F5 on Billy Mitchell.
Hello.
This is for Steve Wiebe deserved that match. Hey. That championship. You know it.
The guy was just trying to ring announce. That's just not right.
He's kissing him.
Ladies and gentlemen. How tall is Adrian Street?
5.
You can feel the
air of expectancy.
Not tall.
It looks short.
Small dude. Yeah,
that was just it. I mean, like to this day, if the WWE show up anywhere where nearby him, he's like welcome backstage. Always has been. It was just the understanding of it. It was like honest with him. He was like, oh, been a foot taller, pal. I would have made you a big star. All that. Yeah.
Where this synth.
See, look at these great strikes, man. Guys don't strike Spivey like this anymore.
Spivey was underrated.
Yeah. Mostly known for replacing, he was like the poor man Barry Windham.
That's why when I was 15, I couldn't stand him because he was fake Barry Windham. And I'm like, you can't fool me. That's not Barry Windham. I mean, that's Barry Windham or whatever. But I loved him in the Skyscrapers and Waylon Mercy was one of the best.
Waylon Mercy
is awesome. Yeah.
He's awesome. Yeah.
But his body was too broken down at the time. That Waylon Mercy gimmick was way ahead of its time.
Yeah, ahead of its time, man.
Definitely. I've been in limbo for so long.
I'd have to call this the Battle of the Balls. Battle of the Balls.
Battle of the what? The what?
You heard him.
Oops, didn't mean to turn all the way down.
Battle of the Bulge?
This is a battle royal, I guess. I mean, they never really did they announce?
Yeah.
We might have missed it.
What was it? What was it? The legendary California battle royal every year? It's seen better years.
Like the Stu Hart.
Hey, what the hell am I doing in this movie?
Josh Brolin. See, nothing gentlemanly going on here.
No. America. Mask has got to win, right?
You know what? I have no idea what's going to happen in this Verkakta movie. I have anything could happen. I would hopefully someone gets. Hopefully everyone gets decapitated.
I mean, they did introduce Adrian Street as a character. So.
Cowboy Steve DeSalvo.
Oh wow! So you can get pinned in this.
Oh,
meat packing. But look at
the meat packing plant. Hey, don't let Max see this. Don't let Max see this.
Yeah. No kidding.
No dog pile on the rabbit spot.
Oh, no.
I'm just trying to sell some sodas.
They're going to have to take him to a medical facility.
The nearest medical facility.
Oof, that was a nasty spell. There's like Bill Watts. Is Bill Watts booking this? There's no pads out there.
The commie's eye.
The commie. Yeah.
Where are we now?
L.A., I believe. Yeah.
The parking garage where we saw some of that California footage back in the day.
Ooh.
Ha. Is that a Shasta?
The fan club guy is jumping around with wads of cash in his hand.
Why?
Things are looking up.
Yeah.
So this is 85. He's the eagle. He's working. Okay, Spivey's right at this point. He's either still working Crockett or they shipped him down to Central States that they did with a lot of the lower guys. And was he just visiting in L.A. and
weird? Or he got cast. The sound effect for the punches is fucking hilarious.
Uh-huh.
It's the same. See.
It's like a video game. It's like a video game.
Yeah.
It's like Double Dragon.
Merlin Olsen?
The chase.
Is this guy also doing a Crocodile Dundee gimmick?
No, that's the Deliverance. Flashy Deliverance.
That's John Tolos in a Greek, ABBA outfit, apparently. Yeah.
Flashy Deliverance. I like that as a
Flashy Deliverance.
Flashy Deliverance sounds like one of those tag team names WWE did in the late 2000s when they put two guys together. Flashy someone.
Two cruiserweights.
Yeah. Kofi was in Flashy Deliverance at one point.
Had the belts three times.
Really weird.
Ooh.
In the Hall of Fame. Like
three times. The mask. Yeah.
Oh, I can't recognize who the big... Bite, kick, scratch, poke, twist, mutilate.
Somebody stop me.
Smoking.
Oh, Pepsi.
We usually don't serve in the front row, but
do that Calgary Cannons games.
You're a peanut bag thrower, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he was.
I told you. Yeah, we got to throw peanuts out into the crowd, and I threw a bag out over the backstop that tore on the top of the backstop, and peanuts just poured onto the audience. It was the best.
Yeah, but
I was laughing so hard.
The tragedy was there was a visit from a school for kids with peanut allergies.
All children.
And they were all looking up at the same time.
Up at the same time, man.
No, children, run! Looks like we're in the final four there, Maskey. He'd be a good cartoon character, Adrian Street. Why don't you let me drive? He's kind of got a bit of a James Mason to him. More of a James Mason. Your most convincing portrayal, I assure you.
No, please, come inside.
There's a tad of John McCheever in there.
I love James Mason.
Me too, dude. I love James Mason so much.
He's like a little bit of Huckleberry Hound.
Yeah.
Like a bit of Snagglepuss.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen Bigger Than Life? the same director as Rebel Without a Cause. Oh man,
it might have.
That's crazy. The drug addict who thinks about killing his son.
Oh no. Bigger than life.
We got yeah, bigger than life. It's nuts. Nicholas Ray.
Sorry to interrupt. We've got juice.
Yeah.
In a Hollywood, I'm sorry. I said Hollywood movie. I mean, it was filmed somewhere near Hollywood. Oh, who's this guy?
What? Just a fair.
Off Hollywood.
Oh, no.
It's going to happen again. It's going to happen again.
Oh, no. He's going to decapitate this motherfucker.
Why pick decapitation? You know?
Because it's hilarious.
Anybody can do that.
Uh-oh. Oh, it's Magnum. Oh.
No,
it's Mad Dog.
No, not out in the rain.
Sacred blood.
It is Jean Reno.
It's Mad Dog.
Jean Reno.
So Mad Dog is alive.
Is alive and.
And not the mask.
Dude, he looks just like Magnum TA in this footage. That's nuts. I was such a huge.
Is he going to go over the top rope?
Magnum Brady, at the time, me and my buddies were teenagers and Philly fans, so of course we cheered the heels.
Yeah.
But I loved Magnum TA. I thought he was just
he's so coolest. Good.
He was so good, and he was such a badass. I loved him.
Yeah.
Magnum Tully, I Quit in the Cage is my favorite match of all time.
I love Tully too. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I love him too. Oh, here we go. So who's the mask? Who's it gonna be?
Damn it.
It's his brother, obviously.
It's the guy who got decapitated. He somehow had his head reattached.
Yeah.
He somehow had his head reattached.
Fan cam footage there, it looked like.
I bet you they take that mask off and there'll be Frankenstein stitches, and it's the guy who had his head popped off.
Haphazard.
That's how I'd book this.
Was Magnum TA's accident.
Ooh, yeah. Hey,
this is how it started.
It is Liam Neeson for sure. It's Darkman.
Oh, he's going to pop his head off. I think I'm right.
Except it's not the Liam Neeson Darkman. It's Larry Drake. It's
Damn, dude, he looks. I can't get over how much he looks like Magnum.
Yeah. The flashback. I see that.
I think my theory.
They had an endgame in mind. I think this is better than the wrestler.
Are you defending this?
Better than the wrestler, I'll say.
Oh.
A lot more laughs than the wrestler.
Yeah.
Bing. Stars on the side of tights with the underwear on the outside. It's the best.
It's insane. The movie's insane. It's absolutely insane. There's no way this could have made any money.
But I was aware of it. As a teenager, I was aware of this thing's existence. And we watched everything back then because it wasn't a lot. We watched every dumb thing. We didn't watch this one. John Tolos has got to get involved in this shit. You know, he's like,
Flashy deliverance.
Vince McMahon saw this. He's like, I got it. I'm going to call you the coach. And we're going to put you in sweats.
Yeah.
Ooh. He's covered. The Crimson Mask.
Wait, why is he having
flashbacks?
But why is he having Skull Crusher flashbacks?
Because he was there. Remember, he was supposed to have been decapitated at that show, right?
Yeah.
But he decapitated Skull Crusher. Why is he having Skull Crusher's flashbacks?
He's having flashbacks of his most traumatic moment.
Oh, okay. It just seems from the perspective.
And it looked like Papa Shango stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, this song is just the shit.
Yep. Always believe.
Vince DiCola. Again, that's who did the music. Music for Transformers the movie.
Let's see. It's Bone Crusher. Is this Bone Crusher? Bone Crusher with his head reattached.
It was never left.
That's my.
It's actually his face.
Oh, Tolos ruined it. He ruined it.
He's a clone.
Oh.
Are you sure it's not? Oh, what's that? Dean Stockwell. Like, great. Come on. We got to get out of here, Scott Bakula. Sean had the best question. Had a good question here. Quick question. What the fuck was any of this?
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah, who's this for? Who's
all right? You got the mask. Who the fuck is it?
Oh, who is it? It's him. It's his face.
It's, yeah, it's like the cave in Empire Strikes Back.
Oh, it's nobody. We've never met this guy.
I don't know who that is.
It's Ed Whalen again. Exactly, haphazard. Yeah, say we both said it at the same time, man. Hilarious.
If they don't,
it's Ed Whalen saying,
if they don't cut to them going, that guy is so and so, that's the funniest thing ever in this movie. It was no one. Sheepskins do not buy condoms here.
Yeah. No. At least discount condoms. Never a good idea.
So what's he doing now?
Seat covers for your eye.
No, I got a couple. I just have them. We call them seat covers.
Good, he got a job.
Sewing seat covers.
I've been napping for the whole show. The flames went late last night.
Very good show. Any chance I can do Ed Whalen? So you know, who does that guy remind you of on the right there? He's an actor. I think we've said a couple.
I said David Hyde Pierce.
Yeah.
On the right, he kind of looks like a young David Letterman.
Right, I see it.
Yeah, this is this epilogue has completely lost me. I have no idea.
Yeah.
I think they filmed this early on.
So it was no one? I don't understand.
Yeah. I don't get it. Space somewhere. And I need that boom boom
big ending, you know? And that's why I'm here to talk to you, Tweed. Oh, he does have a big ending for his documentary. He's,
I don't know. That was a pretty good ending. we could have ended there.
I mean, really, I mean what do you say? I mean, yeah, it sucks that it was nobody. I mean, that's like, what about dinner? It would have been like if they had actually unmasked the Black Scorpion and it was Al Perez and everyone
was if it was Adrian Street.
Wait a second, you were in the match earlier. I'm full of surprises, love. You know what I mean? Yeah, they got some chicken there that's in the sign. It's Steve. Are you Steve Zahn? Is that who I think you look like?
he gets brutally murdered by a car.
A.S. Guerrero.
Tom Snyder was in this. Holy shit!
What? I thought that was him.
If they didn't see, they had a missed opportunity for Tom Snyder to beat the shit out of Wally George. You could have booked that on pay per view, and I would have been there.
Yeah, the epilogue is just atrocious. Yeah. Biff. No.
Vince Biff Smith.
Biff Smith.
Ladies and gentlemen, Grunt.
Leslie Lichtenstein. Come on.
Was that? That was Grunt. That was called Grunt.
Yes, you're welcome. Are we hearing the song one more time on the way out?
I would imagine so. Sound by Glenn Sound.
Well, I certainly hope they play another song that I enjoyed.
Nope. It's Wrestling's Night. For your consideration.
Oof.
Best song.
Boy.
Billy Joel. We'd like to welcome Billy Joel playing.
Hey, Jennifer, thank you for doing catering. We'll give you a shout out. Jennifer's place.
Here we go.
Jennifer made these beans.
Okay, Mag Dog Joe Caruso was played by Greg Magic Schwartz.
And it was Dick Baer. Oh, is that the Steven Destroyer Cepolo with Dick Murdoch? Or no?
It might have been Richard Beyer. It might have been.
Yeah.
Without the mask?
Adrian Street, Miss Linda. There we go.
Themselves. Victor Rivera. The Terrible Two. Irish Pat Barrett. Okay. The Sweetest Eagle. Count Billy Varga. Albert Pugliese.
Well, there's the human pyramid here.
Oh, here they go.
Ludicon.
Pete Marquez. I've seen Pete Marquez on the Houston.
The Giant Goon. Is that the guy covered in shit?
Yes. Jerry Landrum is the Giant Goon.
Female wrestlers. Okay.
Brick
DeSalvo. Okay. So here's that. Yeah. Okay. So there's Steve DeSalvo. There's Spivey.
Woody Farmer. Wrestling Black
Tonight.
Hawk.
Shannon Up performed Wrestling Tonight.
It was Shannon Up.
Do you think they played it at Woodstock?
Woodstock.
They opened with it, yeah.
Opened with Wrestling Tonight.
Hey, you know what? I used to watch the Shana syndicated show on Saturdays, and this came out in '85. I might have heard this song. My wife accidentally insulted Bowser once at a fundraiser. That was hilarious. He was a celebrity, but he didn't look anything like he did, obviously.
And she was bad mouthing Sean on awe.
No, she was part of the organization, and she walked over to the guy running it and like interrupted Bowser and be like, "Hey, where do you want me to put the, you know,
at the Oscars this year, Dustin Hoffman?"
Ladies and gentlemen,
performing Wrestling Tonight, their nominated song, Shanana.
Shanana.
You know, I heard we were going to have...
That would be John Travolta, if John Travolta was...
When I heard that we were going to have the Boom Vancouver City Champion on the show, I scoured the internet for something appropriate to show him. You're welcome, Brady, hey, well for done, Grunt, buddy. Yeah, the wrestling yeah. movie.
Thank you very much, man. That inspired me to continue on, not yes. just in, not just in wrestling, but in life.
Good.
And... All right, yeah. So here we go. I learned a few new moves.
So we will
get to come out to that song. You got to come out to the song.
Wrestling tonight. So we will get a good match. I know Brady and I are both big fans of Muda, but yes. Here's Dick Murdoch.
Oh, okay. What he was like as a human being aside, Dick Murdoch's one of my favorite in ring performers.
Yeah.
But what year is this?
I don't know.
There he is.
Oh, there's Gary Hart.
This might be 89. This could be really good.
Yeah, so this is why Kelly couldn't be with us tonight. 89 haphazard says. Kelly couldn't be with us today, but put together this playlist.
I'll show you my little Muda here.
Hey, no. Hey, it's a family show. Don't show us your little Muda.
He's got his awesome. removable.
Nice.
Nice.
Pretty cool, right?
That's awesome.
Can you fill it with green mist? That'd be awesome.
That would be great. That would be cool.
Push on the head.
That would be cool.
No, there's three different buttons for the three different types of mist. If you hit the wrong one, you blind your sister forever.
So, NWO Wolfpack Sting, I think. Face paint,
right?
Yeah, they were. I've heard all the stories about like Jim Ross and a few others were suggesting that we need to turn Muda babyface because he was the coolest fucking thing they had.
Yeah,
and he was good looking. Jim Ross would always be like, "And whenever I come pick up a check at the office, all the ladies in the secretary pool would come down to see Muda." and Gary Hart kept talking him out of it because it was kind of like Gary Hart's meal ticket / you know, who knows, whatever. Gary Hart was pretty cool, but he could have been a monster baby face in 89.
Oh yeah,
it was on the power hour, and you gotta think, Jim,
you think even just for like merchandise sales and stuff, you could have this guy's a baby face, right?
Like, I was out of watching wrestling at the time. I'd fallen out of it, and I was going to college, and I occasionally would catch something. When I'd catch Muda, I'd be like, okay, I'm watching this.
Yeah.
This guy's amazing.
Feels like he's already, he bit the bit into the pill too quickly. So he's going to have to keep his mouth closed for this whole match.
Shit. Cornette was talking about some of it, times of using an actual condom, holding whatever.
There you go. There you go. See, and I can tell. There you go. Sean is saying, just have him blow the mist to save Sting, and it would have gone over huge.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Nora's got it. We really want the Archduchess to at some point
get blown in the face with
green mist in somebody's face.
Someone's got to blow mist in her face because that's what I. Yeah. I was a Philly fan. That's how I'd book that.
Okay. Great.
Is she going to spray in someone's face grape juice?
Muda from the ring. Muda's got to be very cautious here with a man like Murdoch because Murdoch is no stranger to champions.
I love Gary Hart as a performer. His book, his unreleased book is tremendous. But I always used to drive me nuts when people would be like, "Oh, it doesn't get sucked about him unless he couldn't bump." And I was like, motherfucker survived a plane crash. Give me a break. One of the best talkers in the history of wrestling.
Well, Gary Hart's known Dick Murdoch for quite a few years. He realizes exactly how dangerous Murdoch can be, and by the same token, Murdoch gives Hart that credit. You got to think Murdoch.
Murdoch's one of those guys when you first saw him when you were like 15 or 14, you first see him and you're like, who the fuck's this guy?
Yeah.
And I could look at him.
Yeah.
And then you start watching him wrestle and you're like, oh, he's so good.
Yeah, the aforementioned Kelly T. Nelson, our buddy, and you, Johnny, were associated with that. Like, I remember that greatest wrestler ever that they did on PWO for a while back then, that big controversy, whatever. But as that was being revealed, there were certain wrestlers who I'd never really heard of, including Dick Murdoch. And he was one who was like a revelation to me, like going back and watching his matches. Him and Jim Briggs were the two biggest, kind of like, oh my God, where have these guys been my whole life? Exactly what he tries to do in the opening moments of most of his matches. Well, he always got the knee from the top rope that he did in the movie is such a crazy finisher, man. Really get over now. Yeah,
and some of the bad talk on Murdoch outside of, you know, everything he believed in life.
Oh yeah, garbage human being.
That they're like, well, sometimes he wanted to go out there and just do a Three Stooges routine and have fun. I'm like, good.
Yeah.
I've seen some of his.
That's part of what I meant. Like, he was entirely unique, yeah, man.
His staggering around like he's a Popeye villain. He just got the shit kicked out of him.
Yeah, kind of Harley it. Race is somewhat similar. Muta holds on to the top rope, getting that
additional leverage. But this Sunday night. A lot of Three Stooges. Murdoch is. Okay, the one thing me and Dick Murdoch would probably have in common is that we could like meet in the middle about was if we sat and watched the Three Stooges.
Race. You were going to say race.
You were totally.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Thanks, close.
Thanks, Travis.
This close.
Thank you. Hey, I was born in Kentucky, you know. I also like to throw beer bottles out of moving car windows at street signs.
Oh, boy.
We're from Alberta, so who doesn't?
I'm a knowledge that I'm advising the dynamic dudes now, and I say that the dynamic dudes, if they're overlooked,
dynamic dudes,
the dynamic dudes, a lot of
people in the world, that's Johnny Ace and
Shane Douglas,
right?
Yeah,
with their skateboards.
That's right.
Yeah, with that Johnny Ace couldn't ride one, so he had to carry it down. Shane could.
Yes, so funny. Haphazard saying they should have had Muta turn face in 90 after Sting got injured. Like, kind of like how Nikita turned face after Magnum got hurt.
Well, there's, you ever heard the famous story about, it was in Philly at the Civic Center. I wasn't at this show, but Dynamic Dudes were on. I can't remember who they were wrestling. It might have been Midnight Express. So it's Philly. And there was a gigantic assignment on bed sheets up in the cheap seats where I would have been sitting that said, Shane sucks Johnny's dick. And people talked about this because it was gigantic. And Cornette heard a story once, like they were backstage and and John Laurinaitis was moping about something like, what's wrong with you? Oh, no, apparently I suck his dick and like walked away. So
hilarious. Like,
that's Philadelphia for you. Those Civic Center crowds were a raucous place to be as a 16, 17 year old.
Are they classified as WCW in 89?
No, not. They're just, it was just on the cusp right around here.
Right.
I think the sale might have already 89 happened.
Is a legendary, well, it's a legendary year for Ric Flair, but also for this territory, right?
Yeah, in ring, but they didn't make a dime because there was a lot of bad, too.
Yeah.
I love it. I have a fondness for it. Your all-time heroes as far as announcers. During my wrestling break, at least on Wednesday nights, every 2-3 months, they'd have Clash of Champions. It's like, I got nothing else to watch on a Wednesday night, free pay-per-view level wrestling. So I was more aware of what was going on in WCW, more or less.
Yes, the Outsiders. Outsiders, Muta. And I'm not going to tell you anymore. You'll see tomorrow night
exactly what I'm talking about. I don't think you'll think I'm overreacting. This is not one of Dick Murdoch's better matches.
They're going long here. So. This Saturday night,
Saturday night at 6:05. Well, you're not a guy given to exaggeration, Jim. Just like when you say that I'm your favorite.
This was also great commentary at the time, Cornette and Jim Ross.
I was
going
to say Ross and
Dan Rather getting the opportunity to work with Walter Cronkite, but maybe Rather wouldn't be as gracious about working with an old master as you are with Gordon Solo.
I'm really looking forward to it. He's one of my all-time.
So I'm taking me and my buddy are taking my nephew again. I mentioned Dynamite in 2 days. They're coming back to Colorado. Should be fun.
Think they're going to ask if they can call you Denver again, and you're going to go.
They've been advertising it not as Denver, but as in like the Denver area or outside of Denver. But I'm wondering, because they played at the same place about 2 weeks before the pandemic shut everything down. And Justin Roberts comes out before the show and is like, Broomfield, is it okay if we call you Denver? And everyone. Really? And everyone's going basically, yeah, sure, it's fine. And it dies down, and I scream, Broomfield, fucking represent! It's like 3, 2, 1, countdown.
Fancy spin kicks while Murdoch had a hold of his leg. Murdoch avoided that. Muto went for Murdoch's leg. Murdoch managed to snap him down into a small package. Murdoch is for the most part, countering, maybe not out wrestling, but countering Muto.
This is similar to the tactics that Antonio Inoki had with.
Trying to think, like, is this just, this can't just be TV. What is this?
This
on?
Is, no, they did matches like this on just TV and WCW at the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, but wouldn't we be getting, like, some sort of, we'll be right back!
Oh, I didn't even notice there was no commercial break, but.
So I feel like this must be part of, like, a Starcade or something.
Maybe. I no, not that I can.
There was kind of no, there was no, like, set that they walked out of. Right?
No,
yeah. Like, good point.
Than he ever has been. I was just figuring it was on an episode of, like, maybe not world,
will
not
he
worldwide
grab that
or Saturday night.
Man, that guy's been doing the Gary Hart's been doing
the towel flick.
That asshole in the locker room. It's my thing. Come on, I'm Gary Hart. I whip towels. Fuck off, Gary. That hurts.
You got me right in my balls, Gary. Got me right in my balls.
Look at the mark you left.
That was so close to my eye.
Another right. Murdoch was suckering the great Muta. Murdoch could have caught Gary Hart there, but he suckered the great Muta into trying to come up from behind him.
Yeah, like, I don't think we're going to see a Muta shining wizard here.
Both these guys just keep going back to this heel hook. That's it. That's the whole match.
This is a worldwide, apparently. I don't know why there's no commercials. Maybe it's the, you know, the full feed, and they just kept talking during.
What do you do to offset Gary? Not gonna hear JR say something inappropriate.
Or they had a couple. They actually had a couple
about a young woman in the front row.
Hey there, Corny here. See their sweater puppies on that gal there. I love when JR gets horny on Twitter. It's so disturbing.
Yes.
Feet up over the ring. You cannot move without shaking that cage. It makes your stomach queasy. But what's more important for anybody who's put in that cage, you're nullified. Your advantage, if any.
It's also the more or less one of the only one of the Conrad Thompson shows that I listen to regularly, because I love listening to Grumpy JR go off on tangents that have nothing to do with what they're talking about.
Yeah,
it's great. I get a kick out of it. Just passive aggressively being mad at people about shit that happened 30 years ago. I can't get enough of it. It's great.
And straw man, always the straw man.
The straw man. I know. It's like, you're like, so JR, how's the weather out there today? Well, it's the sun's shining, Connie. And you know, and I know some people are gonna say, oh, now Jim Ross, he likes the sun. Sun causes cancer, and he's got cancer on. It's like, well, those people looking for clickbait. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? It's so much fun to listen to.
Muta has the illegal advantage. Hart has just managed to make a pass.
Oh, that sucks.
Look at that move.
Yeah, but it's cool.
That's Tommy Young. How dare you, sir?
Yeah, he's been missing. He's been missing that from Muta all night. Though.
I'll tell you what, he hasn't been laid back at all.
Tommy Young has suffered so many. Tommy Young's been knocked out so many times. You got to give him a break.
Anything about Funk?
Chris Nowinski could have a field day with
Tommy Young's brain.
That was me and Danzo used to say Misty, that all the time, yes, because Dusty over relied on that. And Tommy Young used to get knocked unconscious on the regular every show multiple times.
Opening up on the great Muda, the television champion, is in trouble. Gary Hart looking at Murdoch trying to spy maybe another advantage, another chance he might
have. Gary Hart's still alive?
No.
How did he phase out from being on television?
I think the WCW run was about it. I don't know if he ever showed up in the dying days of World Class. Awesome. But,
he's a man.
See, there's your bump. There's your bump, you sadist.
Yeah.
I think that's the only bump I've seen in this whole match.
Right.
Yeah, the only bump of this match, and Gary Hart takes Gary Hart it. Is that why Kelly said this?
Maybe.
Oh, who we got here? This is
Dick Slater.
Oh, Dick Slater. Yeah, he was part of this. There was a cool faction they had called the Slaughterhouse of Foley, Muda, Kevin Sullivan.
Five of them? That'd be really cool.
Managed by Gary Hart. And they had this idea to come out in butcher's smocks, all bloody, like the cover of that Beatles album that you can't get.
Right.
And TBS wouldn't put the blood on it. So they all just stood out there in white smocks and looked ridiculous.
Yeah, that kind of Muda
wins.
That was, yeah, it was pretty.
Wow,
nobody really got to do their thing. Yeah, yeah,
pretty uneventful. Yeah,
yeah, and there could have been a nice clash.
It's two of my favorite in-ring guys. It just that just didn't really. Could have been. I thought Dick Murdoch looked a little lazy in this one. That was another great thing on Murdoch.
And
this is, this is at the end of his career, dude. This is at the end of Murdoch's career. Except when he randomly showed up in the Royal Rumble in 1995, and I thought I was having an acid flashback. What the fuck is... Like, I was like,
is it just an axe handle?
That bad? Are things that bad right now?
An axe handle that hit more rope than head? Yeah. Like, come on. Yeah. That's your role? That's... Like, he was more had something in his hand that I had missed.
Wow. He was more shocked than anything.
Dudes.
All right. Stay tuned, dudes. Okay, hey, I got to run.
Oh, hey, right, Brady. Thank you.
I got to go. Great. Thanks, Brady, guys. Man. That was fun, man. That was fun. Yeah. Good to see you guys.
Yeah, I'll see you in a couple days, champ.
Happy holidays, man. I'll see you New Year's Eve defending the title.
That's right. Can't wait. Okay.
Happy see you
again, bud.
Thank you.
All right. Just as Adrian Street emerges.
Wrestling tonight.
It's probably, it's the other song that we heard, the Adrian Street song we heard. The one about the fat chick.
Yes.
Older than she looks? Or something?
Yeah, you're bigger than you look, baby. You're a bigger bitch. You're a bigger bitch than I've recently seen. I've been walking around and I've seen several larger women, but none of them as big as you, my dear. So anyways, this will be playing while you're flapping around like a beach whale.
Love.
It's going to make you a star, dear.
You'll love it.
I might have seen this.
Yeah, me too.
I think we've seen this.
Sean says, after the break, we'll be back with Adrian's new single. That's a huge bitch.
Also featuring, look at that one.
With the B-side, Time of the Month?
Just a terrible place.
But I can get away with it because I'm so flamboyant.
On the rag?
I call this one grumpy guts because you're so fat.
And I can't seem to please you with any sort of dessert. As I bring it in front of you, your gorging face. What's the problem, love?
Sean says from the new album, Broads, am I right?
Oh my God, Adrian Street. 5 foot four of go.
I know
fuck
I've
yourself.
Seen this. I know I've seen this match.
5 foot four full of.
Didn't we watch? You're right. I could.
I
swear
think
we
may
watched,
have seen this before.
We watched an Adrian Street.
Oh no! Is this?
Match.
It's not on. Lords of the Ring.
No, it's not on Lords of the Ring. I could swear we watched Randy Savage. Adrian Street match Adrian where Street. Where we were trying to figure out if it was the I know what this was on. This was on. We were watching Paphos or Memphis or something.
Maybe yeah.
We were wondering why they were wrestling in the Memphis Coliseum. All
right.
But they were at the time ICW, and we talked about that. I'm sure.
Yeah. I think you're right. I think we got a repeat here. That's fine. It's fine. It's me. You haven't seen me since I've gone full misogyny.
He's like my friend I work with who's the cross-dressing ultra-conservative.
Must be quite perplexing to you.
It's perplexing to me, I'll tell you what.
John saying he hasn't seen this match, but Savage doing the promo on the table was in his War Machine video.
I know I've seen more of this. I think it was when we were watching an episode. I think we were watching an episode of Memphis, and we were wondering why they were showing stuff from Poffo, and they were like, is that... We were also wondering who was announcing, and then we heard it was Lance Russell, and we're like, fuck, that's Lance Russell. What's... Yeah, I know we've seen this. Unless it's an... unless Kelly found another one that looks exactly the same. Nah, and I wouldn't put it past him. He's the Ken Burns of wrestling.
Ken Burns of wrestling.
No, I don't think so.
The original Red Rooster, baby.
The best was he in
yeah,
front of
yeah,
some.
Yeah, I remember
yeah.
this now.
Yeah,
okay,
we've seen this.
Hat.
He puts
yeah,
the
yeah.
hat on.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm in disguise.
My name is Guy. Guy.
Now, come
Guy.
On. This belongs to a young man. This is a young man's seat, Mr. Savage.
Is that Lance? Yeah, it is. It.
Yeah. This is, yep.
I'm going to freak out. Lance doing a macho man. Yeah.
And the kids swarm. Showing.
Yeah, I'm gonna take this camera, kid. You know, like finders, cameras. Yeah, I can
have a camera, a Walkman. Oh no, it's a camera for sure. That's a flash.
Like,
I might work that into my gimmick later. The fedora,
the
I don't know.
The
we'll
camera,
see.
Give the kid the hat.
You yeah. like the fedora?
Downward dog.
That hat wasn't yours.
Impolite, Mr. Savage.
Adrian Street could also turn babyface. He did it in Crockett. Sure. One of my favorite pictures is from a promo. And did this get up. It's Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant, Adrian Street, and Dusty Rhodes. The three of them like pointing
oh,
and telling how they're going to kick
yeah.
someone's ass. Ah, it's the best. It's one of the most pro wrestling pictures I've ever seen.
No, Mr. These, Macho.
These are the heroes. These are the heroes. This cross-dressing, this muscular short man who looks like Betty Davis in Whatever Happened to Baby Jane. a hippie. A biker hippie who looks like he's on tons of meth and a fat guy in the back with a cap. Confess.
Oh, for God's sake.
Oh yeah.
But now I'm gonna. Yeah.
Oh no! Now I'm gonna leave. Oh yeah. Oh.
This is actually all the stalling is so smart on Savage's part because Adrian Street was really good, but couldn't really go super long. So you know you stretch
right,
it
right,
out.
Right. Right. Well, it's a Street that was doing the stalling. Or about
yeah,
maybe,
and then
maybe
Savage.
That's
the way Savage
he wrote
was
it up.
And then Savage wrote it up in a notepad before.
Yeah. Oh, you're gonna stall to watch me put on this hat.
I'm sure we've joked about this. Yes. Now it's all coming back to me.
It was in the telegram that he sent.
Yeah.
Then a young man walking by with seven hot dogs.
Hey, oh, hot dog.
Will inform me that we've gone 7 minutes.
If he has a hat on, we go seven more. If he does not,
that's how Jeff. That's
we go
how Jerry,
home.
That's how Jerry Jarrett sent the messages.
Yeah.
Jerry Jarrett would send the messages through the hot dog boy.
4.5 minutes.
He comes around and goes, Macho Man, 5 minutes, go home.
Raises that hand up, saying that he has a win. He better not turn his back.
Nora doesn't like hot dogs. Isn't that crazy? Isn't that a crazy thing for a kid not to like?
I can understand it. He just hasn't had the right one. How do you prepare hot dogs in Canada is what I'm saying. I mean, what's your hot dog game?
Well, yeah, first, what we do is we wait for them to the hot dog trees to quit freezing so we can pluck them.
Once the hot dog tree thaws out, then we and that's usually about 3 days in August.
Oh boy, boy, the hot dog festival, hot dog plucking fest.
So then you walk up to the first open fire you see. Because they're everywhere this time. So you walk up to the first one.
Uh-huh.
They have pre-made sharpened sticks. They come from a tree, too. And you pick the right one. And then you stick that hot dog in there for a good 45 minutes.
45 minutes?
Oh, yeah. Oh, the fires are cold here, though.
Yeah. You only have 3 days. I only have 3 days to get these hot dogs. So they're good.
A lot of mistakes have been made because people don't know that about Canada, that the fire is cold.
Yeah, that's how we do it.
That's how we do it up here. I know.
Hey, man, when I was up there, I was like getting some McDonald's
spicy pizza. Yeah,
I saw some weird shit. And then that spicy pizza that was the most. I almost threw that through the fucking wall of the goddamn hotel.
Where was it from? Just like
it was called Burning Crust.
It was called Burning Crust Pizza, and I didn't know it was literal.
Shout out to Burning Crust.
Ugh. And it looked delicious, and I got two
more
slices.
Like burning my crust.
Then I had to get a Big Mac at 1:30 in the morning.
That's one pizza. Velvet rope in the middle there. Yeah, it must be to let the wrestlers through.
Please give me this. It's my pen.
Here we go.
I brought this from home.
Adrian Street better not be too overconfident, even though I've seen Randy Savage a long time, and Lance, I haven't seen him in trouble like this, I don't think, ever.
Who's on the jersey there? Is that Tennessee?
Street could also be, though. Be a convincing badass for the gimmick, like, you know, he really danced around the whole, like, he's like, is he gay or is he not? Well, this is his old lady apparently, and it's so weird. It's more glam rock it is.
No, but he would still like, in even in the promo we saw,
In the
Lords of the Ring thing we watched, he's like talking about, and he's strong men and things like that, right? Like,
there was the innuendos, but there was the innuendos and stuff, but
it's what it's supposed to be.
But he was also it was a total glam rock aesthetic. He was doing 70s.
That part is Ziggy Stardust is meant to be, you know, sexually ambiguous as well. Ziggy Stardust.
Oh, I thought you meant Cody Rhodes.
Yes.
Stardust.
Yes, of course, the connections are quite clear. I wouldn't go directly to Goldust. I'd go straight to Stardust.
Okay,
in this essay, I will pause it.
There's this bunch.
Lights, please.
In an era where nobody buys where nobody buys DVDs anymore, they're releasing a Cody Rhodes WWE retrospective.
I heard, which is bonkers,
and it's all just stuff of him as Cody from the first run with two matches with Seth Rollins from when he came back. And I'm like, I guess there's got to be a documentary on this thing. But
what
the fuck? Who buys? Is Cody? Does Cody know something we don't? He's like, my fans. They want to own it. They want to feel it. They want to feel it.
The physical media. If you look at what still sells CDs and album sales, it's like country music. still does, right? Like they were the last.
See, I'm the American nightmare, and the nightmare for most Americans out there is they can't afford all your fancy streaming services.
They still have. This is the opening.
And you can hold it in your hands as I journey back.
Very specific fetish. Thank you, Mr. Street.
Street comes right back at him, man.
That's my only guess, is they think that maybe there's we can move physical media.
The pores. I'm talking about the pores, Travis.
Yep.
The pores wanted to get that Cody Rhodes neck tattoo. It comes with a rub-on. It comes with a rub-on Cody Rhodes neck tattoo.
Right. And you're stuck with it forever. It's permanent.
Yeah. That's the rub.
Man,
you know, you think it'll wear off in a couple of days. That reveal
was the craziest thing. Everyone's like, no, Cody.
Now he's stuck with it forever. Stuck with it, and it looked like everything about his WWE return was done perfectly. Every promo, every match, and the fact that he fucking ripped his fucking pec and came out there and wrestled.
That's just adds to the legend.
That was even better. But all through this, the fucking neck tattoo is just.
I know. It's
breaking away from it.
Like, God, come on, talk to Undertaker. He's like, you know, I know that's gonna hurt more to get rid of than Sarah, but brother, you need to fucking.
Wino forever.
Yeah.
But Johnny dubs it.
He needs to go Russian and do like Crusher? Ivan Koloff actually had a tattoo of a sickle going into an eagle's fucking.
Oh wow!
Doesn't Tyson have a tattoo of Mikhail Gorbachev?
Yeah.
He's got a tattoo of Mikhail Gorbachev.
He has a tattoo, Chairman Mao.
I know.
No, he has a tattoo of Mikhail Gorbachev's splotches.
Just
the splotch.
In the correct.
I want to get them in the exact correct spot.
We had several men study my scalp. On my belly goes the Dusty Rhodes splotch, and up here goes my Gorbachev.
All right, so here we go. So here's Muck and Singh versus Steve DeSalvo.
Oh wow!
We go back to Calgary. Oh, it's been a while. So DeSalvo must have been
Muck and Singh. We'll get to hear
our boy. Lance Russell and Ed Whalen are probably my two biggest influences. And there's our boy, Jim Davies. A night of fedoras, everyone.
As soon as this is over, we'll be presenting the Calgary Stampede Wrestling production of Guys and Dolls. I'll be Lieutenant Brannigan.
Something peculiar going on there. We want everyone to know that the Thousand Island dressing in the salad bar is off. Do not use the Thousand Island.
We're keeping it out for display purposes only.
It really completes the spread.
The table looks
young. Tom Cruise visits Calgary.
Oh, there he is.
Holy shit, look at him.
I remember thinking to self. See, that's what I mean. Like, first time you're seeing a real body in Calgary. He buttered him up constantly. And here's our boy, Johnny's dad's favorite wrestler, Norman the Lunatic.
My dad's. I was just talking about those WCW days. Hold on. One of those Wednesday nights, my dad's reading his paper, and Norman the Lunatic, who was mocking Singh. It comes out on the screen. My dad leans past his paper at Norman the Lunatic. Thought it was the funniest fucking thing he'd ever seen. Because at the time, he was sponsoring a guy in AA named Norman, who was a goddamn lunatic. My dad took on all the lunatics because he was one.
Great.
He was one in 1968. So he would take on the lunatics, and I got to meet him. And he hears Norman the Lunatic, and he looks over his paper at Norman the Lunatic and bursts out laughing, and then called Norman the Lunatic to his face for as long as he knew him.
That's wonderful. This is weird that we're getting this full intro and this is a solid 19 minutes in Stampede.
19 minutes?
Infamous.
That's a long time.
Yeah.
And Norman here was... a better worker than he looked like, But 19 minutes? Are we?
Not a Salvo.
We really had to let that about that.
Barry Williams? Barry Williams worked in Stampede? Does Brady Bunch residuals?
Wayne Hart, the referee.
Okay. Sometimes, I was going to say, he looks like Barry Williams, Johnny, from the Brady
Bunch. You would hate Wayne Hart. When he would get involved as like, he would do like the Eric Bischoff style, like kind of karate kind of thing.
As a ref?
Yeah, when he'd get involved.
As a ref, though.
Because he's not a real wrestler. It would happen like very rarely, but when he would be worked in, that's the way he would be a wrestler. It's because he's a smaller dude than everybody. It was like, he was the guy who knew karate. Really funny.
I thought Eric Bischoff knowing karate was fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
Until like he was like considered a threat. And I'm like,
yes,
he can't do that. I mean, just have him come out in his karate shit, maybe get one or two lucky strikes, and then have Larry Zbyszko beat the shit out of him and end this in, you know, 2 minutes.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So what was the story with? Clearly, Mock and Singh is not Middle Eastern.
Yeah.
Right.
So, or Punjabi.
Yeah. Was he like, did he like have an Akeem?
I mean, that was kind of like Sami Zayn. It was like a Sami Zayn thing.
Right. Good point. Yeah. He hung out with the Karachi Vice, who was Gama. Yeah.
Okay. And so they gave him a name. Got it.
Great Gama, who did have a cup of coffee and WWF as well.
Yep. And Tiger.
I think unrelated. Tiger Ali Singh and Gama Singh. But I know Gama Singh's son is wrestling right now.
Tiger Ali Singh, dude. I remember more about that guy than I should because I was so into watching it. That we all were. People coming over on Mondays and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember the hype around Tiger Ali Singh. And then watching him, I'm like about 27, 20 at that time, and watching him going.
I did hit, you guys can hear Stu.
It sucks.
Stu doing color.
Me. Show. Man, no kidding. All right. So we got 18 minutes to fill. Jim, you said you were in a musical? I didn't ask. Let's stop. Do it from the top.
Oh, James, I need to tell you the theory that I came up with our friend Tom Batista on the podcast we did about Teddy Hart. We're like, okay, Teddy Hart obsessed with cats. Natalia obsessed with cats. What's with the cats? Well, if you were fed a steady diet of cat shit in your scrambled eggs your entire fucking childhood when you were
at
your grandparents' house, something gets into your system, right? And it makes you obsessed with fucking cats
on a molecular level.
Yeah. And toxoplasmosis.
Johnny, that was such
I
a good
smoke plasmosis when I lived with my mother in a tent.
It didn't hurt me at all. I was totally fine.
Yeah, I had to kill it with a slingshot. I did, like rabbits.
I just I put it in ice. I iced it.
I said to mother, I go, these rabbits would be a lot easier to cook if it weren't for these cold Canadian fires.
That's how you bring it back.
Circle.
All right. No, not to wax your car too much, but that podcast was awesome. You and Tom.
Not to wax my car.
Not to pump your tires too much.
But what are you? A gas station attendant? What are you
not doing? Not to jamboree.
Not to change your oil too much here.
It
was fun. We had a good time.
I have no desire to watch it at all. But like, and because it seems like it would be such a toil. But you guys really painted a picture.
It became very evident.
Yeah.
A little bit into it that I was just like, I watched some of it and I had to turn it off and go, I hate this.
It's shocking that it's on the Peacock Network.
That's
it
the
sounds
most amazing
so
part.
Butch, Bush League, man. Is that you're fat? That's what I'm telling you. I'm the Highlander. That's what this means. This hair in the back. Yeah. It's weird. Like he was more, it's the only time I ever saw someone was delivered a black card. You know, they do yellow card and red card in Calgary wrestling instead of getting disqualified. You get two yellow cards.
You get two yellows or a red. Yeah.
A red. Yeah. It's like a red card. They get disqualified, a red card, but I saw a black card, which means an automatic suspension. And I remember it's the only time I ever saw in Stampede Wrestling someone give the middle finger, and it was DeSalvo. Yeah, he just just Roid Monkey. Like he was in WCW a bit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Did he call himself Mongo McMichael? Look at him. He looks looks just like Mongo. Hey, Travis, were you there?
Yes, yeah, there I am.
Highlander.
The guy. No, who's the guy in the tie?
Chris
in the
front Lambert. Here?
The guy in the tie.
Chris Lambert.
Okay, the guy in the tie in the front with Little Orphan Annie.
Oh no, he has no eyes.
No, there's a young orphan next to him in a pink dress. This is bizarre. Is that a cowboy in the middle of the ring?
Of course. Several cowboys in that room, my friend. That place reeks of sheep shit.
That place is guaranteed
to an arm wrestle in the middle of the ring. That's pretty funny.
Yeah, because DeSalvo sucks and they need to fill 19 minutes.
Yeah.
Like I said, and 19 minutes isn't what Norman can do either.
This is Uatu fucking with us.
Yeah. I feel hosed.
I'm going to run to the washroom. I'll be right back.
Dumb question. Mukham Singh is Bastion Booger?
Yes, as well, I believe. I think he was also Friar Ferguson
of
around
course.
That time, too.
Yes.
Bastion Booger. I remember seeing that walk Bastion out on TV, and I was just like, what the fuck is this?
Like gray flesh colored tights?
It was duct tape.
Oh,
he wore fucking duct tape, like straps around him.
No teeth in. Just wonderful,
and his music was just burps and farts.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Mukham Singh had something in his hand, and he gouged it to the throat of DeSalvo. This is the first time in the match that Mukham Singh.
And the Norman the Lunatic character, which it gets shit on. Because of what it turned into, but the original Norman the Lunatic character was kind of great because he was a heel.
Yeah, he was scary. Yeah.
And he was scary. And he came down on a gurney and he was strapped down. And Teddy, and the whole story was that Teddy Long have somehow gotten his power of attorney. and he arranged for him to have day outings, a work release program from the mental institution. And they bring him down on the stretcher. Like Hannibal Lecter,
sure.
With fucking attendants in the fucking in the scrubs, and they let him loose to wrestle the match because that's his job now.
It's therapeutic.
And he'd kill everyone, then they had to calm him down, and Teddy Long would have to warn him. He's like, "You calm down, and we're gonna send you to the electrical shock room and shit like that." They give him, and then sometimes they had to put drugs in him to knock him out and put him back on the stretcher. And then, of course, the end result is eventually Teddy Hart's been using this poor man. And then he turns into a guy who comes out with teddy bears for the kids. All the kids love Norman the Lunatic, and it was terrible.
He's having a good time.
Yeah, these lunatics. I mean, he had a great match with Kevin Sullivan. This is one my dad watched. And it falls kind of anywhere, or even if they called it that. They ended up going into a bathroom. One of them came out with a toilet lid around her head. And my dad thought, oh, Norman the Lunatic's got a toilet lid around his head.
Well, they used to call him the toilet bowl in Stampede. You guys will be happy to know I came around the corner and Katie was sitting on the couch and scared the shit out of me.
Looking at you. Dude, that's all that's going
to
happen. I told
Get
you,
used to
I,
that.
I told James before that as soon as you sent me that picture, I was like, you're going to wake up in the middle of the night one night with that doll just looking at you.
Please be nicer to Katie.
It's so funny.
Do you know what's unnerving is when puppets pant? Like when they're breathing hard. Do you know what I mean? Like they do it on the
how do you sell it? As well. Like that's not an easy thing for a puppeteer to sell. an out of breath Muppet.
It's all in the diaphragm of the Muppet, not the mouth. You gotta
very unnerving.
The back,
like animal. Man. Animals out of breath all the time.
Like the Stelvo is just such a plug, right? Like just a big muscle bound plug. He had no personality.
He looks like currently he looks like what they're doing with Madcap Moss in WWE.
Yeah,
right. Or who's the actor? Or Chris Canyon. That's what he looks like. Or, yeah.
Chris Canyon.
Yeah. Nobody's ready for Canyon.
He looks like if an IROC was a person.
But I tell you, Madcap Moss, they had to do it because his initial heel thing where he came out and wrestled in the shorts with the fucking suspenders and it was the worst. When he goes babyface and his whole gimmick now is that he's a badass fighter who's got a name. Like you could see a boxer with the name Madcap Moss, right? That sounds good. So it's stripped down to the essentials. They went all the other way.
Yeah, it's crazy to see. I got to see him in person. He was against, McIntyre was against Corbin, right? In Texas. It's weird to think that happened in the year 2022 of our Lord. It's crazy. I can't get over, like, it's crazy that I got to see. That was a pretty special, like, when people are talking about the best night of wrestling in 2022, a lot of them are talking about night one of WrestleMania. It's wild that I ended up there. Yeah, it's crazy.
I thought he was going to talk about Boom and be like,
no. That's where it ended. Like, I mean, that was all part of it too. It's crazy.
No, that shit's a nightmare.
Yeah. No, it's yeah, like honestly, no, like look at Wild Eyes. Yeah. I warned you piece of shit.
Oh, is that your inspiration for getting involved? Because Lance Russell never put his hands on the wrestlers.
No, never.
Never.
No, I didn't write it. Hey, man, do you think I booked that match? You think I'd ever dare book the inner workings of a match? Never.
All right, Chris Jericho, we know you've got the ear. You just had him on here.
The ear.
No, I'm 100%. Like, if you watch that match, for the amount of moving parts, that's the most complex match that we've had.
I know, I watched
wrestling that had different people. And yeah, 100%. Brady booked that top to bottom. And he's awesome. Well, now that he's gone, I'll tell you, Brady's got a great idea for our mind for our long-term and short-term, the way he...
Oh, so you're waiting for him to be gone before you start...
before I wax his car. Pump his tires.
Simonize his brakes.
Yeah, but I'll 100%. Like, yeah, he's what they would call the agent. What are you doing
out here? Detail is bumper.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, man. I'm equal parts inspiration, Waylon and Russell, dude. Look at my dorky-ass outfit. That is Wild Eyes.
That's totally Ed Waylon, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, no. Lee. Holy shit. Holy shit. I've never seen this before.
This is crazy.
Oh, my God. They named a place at the Saddle Dome after me.
Yeah.
Piece of shit.
Oh, he kicked him. You know,
boo. Oh, suck a dick,
I wanted to see him get smashed.
I know, I could tell you what it is.
We ain't in Philadelphia, Hedgepath.
Yeah, Lance Russell is on suddenly announcing this, going, it's like, yeah, no, I gotta tell you. Yeah, don't get involved in the matches. What are you doing? Ring a ding ding. I don't know what he's talking about, Dave. The what?
Oh, I've got a.
He was about to get that's what they called that, the Karachi Crunch, the his avalanche.
Oh, all that was in the middle of this fucking match.
Oh, is that Gary Albright? Yeah, that's Vulcan Singh. That's Wheels from Degrassi. The original.
Fucking Wheels.
Yeah.
Yeah, Wheels only got like a one or two appearance.
Away, maybe right?
A different actor.
He did.
That actor died. That actor died.
Yeah, he did. Yeah. He got his life together, and then
in Next Generation, they had to deal with the fact that Wheels killed a girl driving. And
that's there was right. You know all about it. Grown-ups. You know,
I did. I watched The Next Generation.
Wow, I only watched the original. Ah, TSN. I don't know
whether you saw. Yeah, I don't even know where the fuck I am right now.
My wife said and she
would like to try an omelet.
Yeah,
hard family breakfast sandwiches.
Have you had breakfast yet?
We're gonna start a food truck. Food trucks out of it.
Food trucks are the thing.
Man. Yeah, gotta put the cats in the truck. Have them shitting on the ground. We're fine up here.
You ever have raccoon and egg? Kill them with a slingshot, you do. When you live on the tundra in a tent with your mother.
He's getting suspended.
We didn't have a house. We had a hole.
They did. That's the story.
Right? See, and yep. Muckin's got a leg to stand on here.
Yeah,
he's the one. Because Waylon did get him. Like you said, Johnny. Yeah. Waylon got involved first.
You're fired, Ed.
I did not.
I'm not finished. Eddie, go fuck yourself.
Your rules is rules, Eddie. How many times have you left? Why the fuck did you...
Why didn't you go?
Dynamite and Davey Boy was hot.
Why didn't you go call another goal for Hawk and Lube or some bullshit? You'll hold it up for an hour or what?
It should be held up. I think you'll treasure my fat ass.
So they're saying the belt is going to be held up.
Oh.
Look, he looked, dude. That is wild eyes. That's hilarious. It's so funny,
dude.
I have rented a tux.
You have to stop talking about your character as if it's another person.
Yes,
or else I will. Next time I come up there, I will punch you in the fucking.
All right, I got it.
All right, we're back. It's California Championship Wrestling. That's Rivers
Corner.
Right.
Back to California. Look who we got here. Victor Rivera.
California, here we come.
And Steve Strong, so it's another.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next
Steve Strong is the salvo here. This is louder. Quite a bit.
This guy's eyes are so bloodshot that it's insane.
Yeah. Right? We've seen these guys. They're big dude. I want to be in photography.
Victor Rivera. Yeah, Victor Rivera, he was in the movie. Oh, Steve Strong must have been Black Hawk in the movie.
Ironclad.
Chief J. Strongbow. Oh, it's Strongbow Jr. again.
Heel turn.
Here we go.
There's nothing you can do, Stu. You can't take me down, Stu.
Imagine Ed Whalen.
That'd be awesome.
In the meantime, and in between Whalen. Time. Go fuck yourself,
Mr. Whalen.
Mr. Whalen.
No chance. That's what you got. You're ring a ding 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 fired.
Wow. This camera angle.
Oh, those guns.
Rat-a-tat-tats.
Okay, the guns on the back look fucking dope. Sorry.
King Kong ain't got shit on me.
John, you write them, I'll say them.
You better could. As my old friend Dick Lane used to say, whoa, Nelly, anybody knows.
Whoa, Nelly.
That's another Waylandism. Look at their tables there. Somebody's in an arm wrestle.
Yes,
there.
Yes. Ed Whalen invented.
Or a serious discussion.
Ed Whalen invented Whoa Nelly.
Yeah, I know. it's weird that they're like the Golden Globes. Just waiting to get some service. They didn't even expect.
My Uncle Monty. Oh, yeah, my Uncle Monty is kicking the shit out of somebody here. Holy shit.
Yo, Stu, I didn't know you liked to get wet.
It's Sherm
all night long. This is the end. Oh yeah, this is the last 4 minutes. So Sean, you gotta pack him in.
Pack him in, Sean.
And there's more color. Holy shit. Early color.
First you get the money.
Victor Rivera would bleed. Victor Rivera would bleed at the
first. First you get the money, then you get the
the power. Golden Greek. That's Tolos.
Then you get the women, still.
Oh, he's out.
What would be good is if he kept doing it even after Stu had perished.
Yeah.
What are you going to do about it, Stu? Oh, that's right. Nothing.
It's his unrealized dream all those years. Yep. The couple times he quit.
Or cut for time.
Is that a bowling alley?
Looks you like sound it. Like you sound like Burgess Meredith.
Yeah, I do. No. Johnny's the finger. Johnny's the finger. This is madness, this last guy.
Oh, my goodness.
I need to rip my shirt off.
Do you have a nap?
The Cougars in the crowd need to see that the Golden Greek looks good.
Feels like this crowd didn't realize a wrestling match was going to happen here.
I'm just waiting on my cheese sticks.
Have they called her number yet? The Ponderosa is really.
I can't see the Kino board.
Ponderosa. That sounds good. I'm about to have some leftover turkey dinner, y'all.
We had ham for Christmas dinner.
Oh, I saw our buddy. Ben Zani, who's got a new lady in his life, but looks like somebody made a really fine, really nice prime rib. That guy will share some really good work.
A nice what?
Tasty homemade food. Prime rib.
Ooh.
Looked really good.
From beyond the grave, yeah. I got your ass, Stu.
We had a good weekend of cooking. Christmas Eve, we made breakfast as a family. Ooh. I made lunch as a family, and then we had a great Christmas Eve dinner. Cornish game hens.
Wow.
With everything else, smoked on the smoker, together, and then Christmas Day. It was amazing.
We had the best Indian food in Edmonton.
All right,
so it's sucks. Last, is what you're saying?
It's awesome.
70 seconds here in this chaos. That's Steve.
Chief J. Strongbow Jr. Strongbow Jr. I'm sorry.
Want to make sure everybody has a great and safe rest of the holiday season. And
yeah, happy holidays, everybody.
Yeah, and happy 2023. James, oof, really glad, really happy you were able to join us here.
Oh, I'm so happy to be back, guys.
Thanks, James.
We had a great 2022 in terms of guests and everybody, and we're going to keep it going.
Only more to come.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. Johnny, happy holidays to you, man. We miss you. We can't wait. Yeah, same to you, Sean. Everybody on Twitch, thanks for joining us. Moose, Sean, Haphazard, you guys are the best. Kelly, thanks for putting together this mess at the end here.
Thanks, Uatu.
Yeah. James, say hi. Say hey to you and yours, your family.
James,
here's Christmas bloody face.
Watch out for puppets, buddy.
This guy's beating up his goddamn landscaper, and I'm not about it. The Golden Greek stinks.
Fantastic. See you on the flip side.